This is a very passionate podcast. I'm Marian.
Super very passionate people.
I'm very passionate.
Very, very passionate about it.
Very passionate people.
She's one of the most passionate people.
Or maybe you don't know shit and you want to learn from the best.
Very passionate. Well, hello. Welcome back to I Am Very Passionate, a podcast by Mario and Jessica. I'm Mario.
I'm Jessica.
And we're here for what's hopefully a very quick episode.
Let me say that every time.
Well, we do, but like...
No, we're on it today. I have a family dinner at 4.
It is 1:35. We have to keep it brief.
Yes, we can do it. So this week, we have a few icebreakers. They're good. They're relevant.
They're very relevant. Down.
And we are going to be highlighting another woman that we know.
Mm-hmm.
Or that we love, that we know. And admire. I wish we knew her.
But I mean, it's no secret that we admire her because we literally talk about her every fucking week.
Fucking Lizzo. And this is also the perfect week to do it because she has eight
Grammy nominations.
And we are so proud of our girl.
I'm so excited. Some people are like trying to contest it because like Truth Hurts came out like 2 years ago, but there are no rules like that for the Grammys. Like they have specific rules that it has to be relevant or it can be nominated when it becomes relevant. So if it's like a song from 5 years ago, and it suddenly tops the charts now, it's relevant, or it's eligible for a Grammy.
And my favorite thing that's come out of all of this is her Instagram post about it.
Uh-huh.
Have you seen it?
I haven't. Oh. Is it her? I've seen the thing with her butt and Homer Simpson. Is that in regards to it?
Yeah.
What is it?
Okay, I'll show you. And I'll try.
Is she telling him to kiss her ass?
Yeah. But it's not just Homer Simpson. She actually posts her ass.
Well, no, I saw her ass and then they photoshopped her ass onto Homer Simpson.
No, honey. She did that.
Yeah.
She did it. She posted this.
Yes.
And then made that.
Yeah. I saw this post. I just didn't realize it was in regards to that.
Oh yeah. It was Kiss My Ass.
I love her.
Yeah.
I love her so
much. And Kiss Her Ass, because her album is absolutely amazing, and it makes me so happy, and it brings me so much joy, and I feel so much better when I listen to it.
And I swear to God, if she doesn't get at least one Grammy, I'm going to be pissed.
I just want one.
If she gets more,
great.
Fantastic.
We're here
for it. But she deserves at least one fucking Grammy.
Yeah, I agree.
For all the hard work she's been doing, and all the hard work she's done, and we're going to get into that a little bit later.
Yeah, we're so excited.
But we want to start off on a very positive note with that, before we...
With Lizzo's ass.
Before we get into a little bit more sad thing, really quickly, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, one of the most prolific and well-respected Supreme Court justices, is currently in the hospital having fever and chills. So I think she has the flu.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really scary for somebody of her age.
Also, it could be this whole Salmonella E. coli outbreak, too.
And that's fucking
Trump's
fault.
Please don't buy beef right now and be careful.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. So with beef, they haven't narrowed it down to one factory. They haven't. And they haven't narrowed it down to like one state. There's been 11 states compromised and they've come all from different sources.
This is all Trump's fault.
Yeah.
He deregulated a lot of the environmental protections that stopped companies from polluting the environment.
Exactly.
And this pollution is causing E. coli outbreaks.
Yeah. And so we haven't bought beef in like 3 or 4 weeks now.
I had beef pozole like a week ago.
I won't do it. Georgia.
And then I had bibimbap with bulgogi. Like,
I think it's probably safer because he went to a really nice restaurant last night and I think they source here.
Well, let's
so it's
hope.
Not coming from a big place, like traveling all that way. Like it's coming from places here. So, and then prepackaged salads that have romaine.
Oh shit.
Are salmonella right now.
No.
Yeah. So just be careful.
I just had a salad.
So what I was thinking is maybe Ruth Bader Ginsburg could be having like a...
Maybe.
It's possible. Gosh. We hope she gets better though.
Very soon.
She's done a lot for our
nation. Get so nervous every time she gets sick.
Yeah.
Because like, you know he's going to throw somebody in there again and then we're going to have an extreme majority conservative in...
Yeah. So hold on, Ruth.
Ruth, if you can make it until he's no longer president, girl.
Absolutely.
We will... Arrange your euthanasia if you want it. Euthanization, if you want it.
I want to be euthanized.
I don't know if I do.
I do. I don't want to be,
But, like, if you just go natural, like, if you just, like, die in your sleep and you weren't suffering and you weren't sick up until that point.
I'd be fine with that.
Okay.
But, like, if I have a terminal illness.
Absolutely, yes.
Like,
I don't want
to. Take me to Washington State and euthanize me.
Absolutely. No, absolutely. If I have, like, I'm stage 4 cancer, there's no hope for me. I'm just going to be in pain for the rest of my life.
I don't want hospice.
I want to go out with my dignity. Well, not saying that people who don't have dignity, but I feel like I'd have my dignity by making my own decision and not letting it control
me. I feel like I'm wasting resources. For me, that's what it comes down to. Like, I'm going to die. Don't give me morphine. Give me the opioid that's going to put me to sleep and help somebody.
Yeah.
Like, save that for other people.
Yeah.
Oh, I love your next one.
Oh,
the icebreaker.
The Tesla truck?
Yeah, because I was so excited when I saw it and I saw a picture of it. I was like, the fuck is that? That's not a truck.
So, it is a truck.
It does not look like
it's a like truck. It's like an El Camino. Like, it has...
Yeah, I hate it.
A 6-foot bed. It's huge.
Sure.
But, like, it has a Marvel countertop as the... As the fucking dashboard. It is so weird. The wheels look like a plastic toy. And it's like, I don't know.
I'm not into it.
It's ugly as fuck.
I like the Teslas. I like Teslas. I think they're really pretty.
So I watch MKBHD. That's the
only high-end car I would buy.
A Tesla?
Mm-hmm.
But even though they're not that high-end, you could buy a base model for like 30-some thousand.
Sure. But I would, for a Tesla, I want all the bells and whistles.
Oh, okay.
Anything else? Basic.
Like, I understand, like, Marquise Brownlee, who's MKBHD, he's the one who talked about the Google Pixel that you saw the video on.
Oh, I have a Pixel update.
Oh, do you? Mm-hmm. Did you do the space picture?
I haven't done it yet.
Oh, but you updated to it?
Mm-hmm.
Or is that...
What? Babe?
We're gonna get apart.
Okay, love you.
Is that what you meant by an update? Like, you have to update your phone? Or
No. I mean, I have, like, a Pixel update that I'm kind of pissed about that I can't wait to tell you about that I just found out last night.
Uh-oh.
I was really mad.
With your phone?
Mm-mm.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, then, going forward, I watched an MKBHD video about it, and he explained, like, his thought process on it, and I understand now, because the number one selling vehicle in America is a Ford F-150. It has been for the last, like, 10 years.
Not surprised. That makes sense to me.
And then the top five are trucks that look like the Ford F-150.
My dad drives an F-100.
Oh, is that, like, the little one?
It's a Ford. No, it's, like, the original 100 series Ford.
Oh.
They don't make them anymore. And it's been around for, like, 30 years. Oh. They last a long time.
That's wild.
It's crazy.
See, I thought Ford was, like, fix or repair daily or whatever.
I know their gas mileage isn't great, though, except for their Edge. The Edge is supposed to be really bomb. That's their SUV, the economic SUV.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But regardless, he was explaining that trucks are the way to go.
Agreed.
If you want to sell a lot of cars. But at the same time, if they were to just sell an electric version of a Ford F-150, that wouldn't really appeal. They have to be different. They have to stand out. And I was like, I get that. But, like, he's buying one. I was like, buddy, whoa.
I totally get it. I'm with you on that. And that thought process makes sense. But, like...
This is just ugly.
Trucks are usually function over form.
Yeah.
And the form sometimes is nice. And people hop on board with, like, the newer F-100s, 200s, or the 150s, 250s, 350s. They're really sharp looking. And so they keep the basic... style of a truck, and they just kind of, like, upgrade it, make it look more sleek, but it still looks rugged. This does not look like a truck to me.
No,
it's an El Camino. Say that. El Caminos weren't considered trucks. They were considered cars with a bed.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I didn't like it.
But I think it also has, like, the capabilities of a truck in terms of towing capabilities and pulling stuff.
It still looks...
And it's big. It's bigger than an El Camino.
Okay. Because to me, it looks small. It looked like a car. I was like, how is that a truck? But I didn't have a reference point to compare it to. Mm-hmm. Like, there wasn't a person standing next to it. So.
And then also, it has, like, modular, like, a modular aspect to its bed. So, like, you can, like, clip on to hold something down from any, like, there's a whole bunch of railings along the back. And so you can, like, do it anywhere. I don't know. It's
like ladder type railings.
It looks like there's, like, ridges along the thing, and
but most truck beds have that.
But it's not in this regard. Like, it's like those, that ridges is just so things don't roll around.
Oh, okay.
This is like, there's actually something you can plug into it at any point in this truck bed to hold it down. Like, it's functionally smart.
Okay. Well, maybe we're just not down with it because it's so
It looks like a really badly, like, rendered, like, PlayStation 2 vehicle.
Yes. It looks like a video game vehicle. That's exactly what it looks like.
It's super polygonal.
We're going to post a picture because it's so strange.
Of course, but
maybe people will get on board with it. I'm not against the Tesla, although...
I think he's an asshole.
Uh-huh.
I think he's an asshole.
Sure, but I was talking about how much I liked Teslas and how the engine, like the combustible engine that we use in our engines are not great for kinetic energy. So it means that, like, it's really not a sustainable thing because, like... So what it is like kinetic energy is energy that's like building up and then you keep using it. But with a combustible engine, you don't do that.
Mm-hmm.
You build it up based on the mechanics and then all of a sudden you just stop. So all that kinetic energy goes nowhere. And so, like, theoretically, it's not a great machine. But then Daniel was like, that is true, and it would be great if we had a kinetic style engine, but also Tesla engines are just as bad for the environment because we have no way to properly get rid of, like, the batteries used in the Teslas, and, like, you can't fix them. You just have to replace them.
The battery?
The battery, like, the lithium battery that it uses. So I was like, well, I guess the pendulum swings both ways.
Also, there's no way to guarantee that the electricity you're charging it with was not based off of, like, coal. True. Because a lot of our electricity is based off of coal fire.
Very true. Yeah, that's a misconception that people have. They don't think that coal is still being used, but it is
used
all the heavily, time. All the fucking time. So until we can get that under control, a true electric vehicle really isn't going to be a thing.
Although, one cool thing about this truck is they have, like, this panel that goes over the truck bed that you can roll back in, and you can get a solar power panel installed.
Oh, that I love. I am all about a solar panel.
But it's not, like, solar energy in that regard isn't as potent. So, like, it can get you an extra, like, 15 miles if you're out in the middle of nowhere.
That 15 miles is the difference between me and you and Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Absolutely. Absolutely. But it's not something that you can use to consistently power your vehicle.
I'm still all about a solar panel. I would love to do a solar panel roof.
That would be nice.
I would love to do it. But this is not my forever home, so not gonna do it.
But on your forever home, maybe?
Yeah. No, on my forever home for sure.
Okay.
Because I plan on evading the tax laws. Because, you know, you get a tax break if you do something green to your home. But you only get one per year. So if you do a full green makeover, you only get to claim one item as tax deductible. So Mama gonna do one every year until it's done.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm gonna do. Because this is expensive.
Yeah. No, that's really fucking expensive.
Yeah. But I'm all about Tesla. I like it because I feel like it means we're moving in the right direction. The environment is very, very important. But, like, it's still not perfect.
Yeah. And this truck is just ugly as fuck.
And regardless if Elon Musk is an asshole, like, his brain is actually fucking incredible.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Be an asshole. I heard Einstein was a jerk, too.
I'd believe it.
Yeah, why not? You're that smart.
And he married his cousin.
Oh, incest. It's beautiful. BC Andrews wrote a book about that.
It's her kink, guys. Don't knock her.
No, I love it. I think it's so crazy. Like, it's a morbid fascination.
Now, speaking of crazy, Michael fucking Bloomberg.
Oh, I thought we were going for the other one. Okay. Go ahead.
Michael fucking Bloomberg just announced that he is running for president.
Guys, I'm so sorry.
I am so pissed.
Just, like, let him rant. Let him get it out.
I'm not going to rant again. Do it. I'm not going
to
rant again.
You have to let it out.
I just want to say that the number one thing immediately after his name on the docket is motherfucker in all caps. But I've been thinking about this, and this might be good for Bernie and Warren.
I'm convulsing.
Because Biden is a moderate Democrat, and so is Bloomberg. So this could split the vote on them, so neither of them can get a majority and allow Bernie or Warren to get a majority over them.
I'm going
to
rant for Mario, guys. I'm going to read you exactly what he put on the docket. Because it's too good not to. So he wrote, Michael Bloomberg officially joins the Democratic race. First bullet point, motherfucker. Second bullet point, he's a moderate Democrat aiming to defeat Trump and undo the damage he has done. 3, this is clearly aimed to appease rich Democratic voters. 4, he doesn't think any of the current candidates can beat Trump. 5, fuck him. I'm so tired of these super rich white motherfuckers who think they know what's best for non-rich white people. 7, maybe this will help knock out Biden by splitting the moderate vote.
I went through a whole journey.
He like thinking out on this fucking paper. I'm going to print this one and frame it. It's my favorite. Mario and I do our docket update separately. Like, we don't sit down together. We sit down and we go, this is what we're going to talk about. Mario does his research and he puts what he wants. I do my research. We put what I want. And then we both just add icebreakers, right?
Uh-huh.
When I saw this morning.
Were you laughing?
I had tears. Because I went to go put all my Lizzo stuff in, and I was like, Michael, what the fuck? And then it said, like, fuck him, and I was like, oh, shit. Guys, I didn't say anything, but I was waiting. Because Mario tends to, like, lose his shit about the dim. We have a lot. I'm tired. I have to listen to this shit. I'm like, I've checked out until Super Tuesday. I don't give a fuck.
He's not even participating. So Super Tuesday is not the first time they vote. That's just the first time where a majority of people do. There's like 4 states that vote before Super
Tuesday.
But I
don't care until Super Tuesday.
He's not allowed to be voted on in those places.
So that's more infuriating because why are you wasting our time?
Exactly. He's just confusing people and just, I fucking hate him.
Fuck him.
Fuck him.
I feel like out of solidarity. Fuck you. There's no way. I like to argue, but I'm not arguing with Mario anything political. I'm not doing it. No. I won't. I can't. He's so much more passionate than I am. I have strong feelings, but Mario really just wants to, like, sit everybody down and be like, I'm picking five candidates. Everyone else can go to fucking hell.
You all can have a place in the candidate or in the cabinet or
Elizabeth Warren. Biden.
No.
I love Biden. You have to throw Biden in for me. I gave Elizabeth four. You get five people.
I guess. But I feel like if we don't include Bernie.
What did I say, Biden?
Yeah.
I meant Bernie. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm tired, guys. I meant Bernie.
It's okay. Okay.
I like Bernie.
I mean, I like Biden as a person in terms of the memes. I love the Joe Biden memes back when Obama was president.
I love Biden. I really do. I think I just find him so personal. I really, really like him. But the thing is like, he's not with what I think the vision should be for our country.
I agree.
I'm not saying that he is not like a great, I think he's terrible, but like, I think I'm awesome and I shouldn't be president.
Yeah.
I think that's fair, right?
No, I agree.
Everyone can be president.
I don't think he has it.
I don't either.
But moving on, I just wanted to quickly touch on this because we mentioned the Harriet Tubman movie.
Mm-hmm.
When the guy who helped write this movie,
yeah,
originally was trying to write this in 1994.
Yeah.
And
Harriet Tubman, the movie came out, guys, in case you didn't know. I can't wait to go see it.
And he said when they were first coming up with it, somebody said, or a movie executive said, well, let's get Julia Roberts to play Harriet Tubman.
Harriet fucking Tubman.
And they're like, what? And the guy's reasoning was, it was a long time ago, so nobody really know the difference.
Harriet fucking Tubman. She was my idol growing up.
I watched
Roots in 1996. I became obsessed with the slave trade. That's when I was like fully exposed to it and understood it. Knew that shit was being whitewashed. I read everything that I could. And Harriet Tubman was like my idol. I love Harriet Tubman.
Did you see what Kitty posted, the meme she posted?
No.
Oh my God.
Hi,
Kitty. Kitty of Kitty Tour Dates. Love her. Check her out.
Let me see. Oh, shut the fuck up. Big mistake, Masahiro. Oh my God. I love that people are so funny.
So essentially, it's Harry. It's
we'll repost it.
It's
so good.
It's Julia Roberts dressed up as Harriet Tubman,
mm-hmm.
And the quote is "Big mistake, Massa. Huge." If you haven't seen Pretty Woman,
you don't get it. Go watch Pretty Woman and then go watch Harriet Tubman. But try to make those two reconcile in your brain. That's why this is fucked up.
Exactly. I cannot.
God, that's so terrible. Can we talk about your baby?
Baby Yoda.
Mario's obsessed, guys.
He's so okay. So if you don't have Disney Plus,
which I have a tangent for Disney Plus too, so we're good here.
Oh, get Disney Plus.
Mm-hmm.
It has The Mandalorian, which I will say so far hasn't been the best show because I think it's kind of boring because there's not a lot of dialogue. I have a lot of friends who like it too. It's like maybe I just need to rewatch it and like try and look at it from a different view.
Yeah.
But like the first two episodes, there's not a lot of talking and it's just a lot of doing, and that's not really my favorite kind of storytelling.
Stuff like that.
Like I want to understand why.
No, I can't. But that's you take it in from the context. Oh, I love it. I love stuff like that. I haven't watched Mandalorian, but I love movies like that.
Regardless, there is a breakout star of The Mandalorian. He or she, they actually don't know. They've been calling it it.
Mm-hmm.
It's called The Child, but he's pretty much Baby Yoda. Everybody's calling him Baby Yoda on the
internet. Mario wrote Baby fucking Yoda, though,
he's
guys.
He's so cute.
He's super cute.
He's so cute. Oh my God. Even my mom was like, oh, and she doesn't like sci-fi shit. But the memes are so good. Even my dad's like in on the memes, and my dad's always late to the party with the memes. Like he shared with me like a fucking,
You said even my dad isn't on it, guys.
My dad's never in on the memes. He sends like old ass memes. Like, oh my God. Like he sent like a Doge meme the other day. And I was like, I love Doge, but like that was from like what, 2015?
Yeah.
Like buddy, get with the times. Although he does love the cat one.
I love that one.
That's my favorite currently. But he sent me one and he said, this is your sister. And I was like, oh shit. So I read it and it's the woman yelling, my child has ADD. And the cat's saying, yeah, all different dads. And I was like, oh my God, dad. Oh my God.
I love it. Way to go, Daddy Mario.
My dad.
That's awesome. Wow. I'm so impressed.
I know.
That's where you get your shadiness from, right there.
I guess.
Your savageness. Although, he just doesn't release it often.
I don't know. My mom can be nice nasty.
Yeah, but you're pretty savage. I wouldn't say that you're nice nasty.
I can be nice nasty.
You can be, but I would not say that's your...
My forte.
Yeah.
Is it forte?
I think it's forte. Okay. Fort would be.
Well, I've heard people say no, people mispronounce it as forte, but it's fort.
I'm pretty sure it's a music term, and it's forte, because it has
an E. I don't know. Yeah. If no, you know, send good. An email. Let us know. But Baby Yoda, so fucking cute.
Mario was like, have you seen Baby Yoda? On our messaging thing at work, and I was like, yes, I saw Baby Yoda last night.
Oh my god. I want a toy of him. I want a plushie. I want everything Baby Yoda.
You have to crochet yours now.
Oh my god, I can crochet a Baby Yoda. I keep forgetting I can crochet. Holy shit.
Because you're not doing it every day. Because you're not at work doing absolutely fucking nothing with our time.
Yeah, and you know, like when you said, like, I really don't like just sitting there, now that I realize, I probably wouldn't either. If I were trying to go back, I'd be so bored.
I hate it.
Because time flies at my new job.
Yeah.
Like, I will literally blink and I've been there for 3 hours and it's time for my first break. Yeah. I'm like, oh shit.
Mario and I used to fill our time with talking about podcasts, which is how this podcast idea came up.
Crocheting. It wasn't for nothing.
No, it wasn't. And we're not knocking it. We're grateful for the position that we're in. But, like, I would do 2 hours worth of makeup at work sometimes. Like, I would sit down with my makeup case and a mirror and just go to town.
Mm-hmm.
I would do my nails at work. Like, it's insane how much time we just sat there.
Yeah.
And I don't like sitting there doing nothing.
I crocheted so much. I've crocheted at so least, like, 50 plushies.
He broke the crochet needle.
I did.
I fixed it. It's broken.
It was my favorite one.
I know.
I fixed it.
Guys, so
Gorilla
much.
Glue is everything.
Sure.
But regardless, Baby Yoda's amazing. If you haven't seen The Mandalorian, at least check it out to see Baby Yoda. I love him. Moving on.
I want to do Paris next.
Okay.
So that we can...
Have you seen Paris is Burning?
No, I don't watch... Well, I do watch, but I don't watch like celebrity porn.
Celebrity porn.
Isn't Paris is Burning? Isn't
no.
That?
Honey. Oh, sweetie. Oh, my
what
God.
Paris is Burning
is this amazing documentary.
A Night in Paris.
Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Girl.
I thought we were going to talk about Paris Hilton's porn video. And you were excited.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Paris
oh, my
is
God.
Burning is a great movie.
I mean, it might be burning as much.
You can leave it in. It's A Night in Paris.
Oh my god. That's, so you've seen Paris is Burning.
Yes, but I was thinking.
Oh my
I
god.
Don't know what I was thinking. I have Paris Hilton on the brain. I don't know why.
So if you all don't know who are listening, Paris is Burning is a very groundbreaking documentary from the
90s. Not a porn.
Not a porno. About the ball scene, which is like where a lot of drag originates and a lot of drag terms and a lot of current slang originates from. And it was just the queer scene
it's
of black
really
and Latino
good.
People just going and living openly and being themselves. And... It really touches on It touches on a lot of the hardships of gay people. I mean, there's literally a person who is in the documentary, halfway through the documentary, she was found dead, stuffed in a mattress. Like, this is a reality of especially being a trans woman in America.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, they did not pull punches, but it is such an amazing, amazing documentary. And they're re-releasing it with an hour of unseen footage, and I am so fucking thrilled.
Me too. I thought Mario wanted to watch his sex tape together.
Oh god, no.
I would have been down. I'm not against it.
I can't with Paris Hilton. I'm sorry.
I actually really like her.
Paris Hilton?
Yeah.
I really liked that show she did with Nicole Richie where they go and do the
Simple
different jobs.
Life.
Yes, I loved that shit.
Yeah.
But I loved it for Nicole because Nicole was the one with all the really clever lines. And Paris was just kind of there like, yeah.
That's why I like her.
I've never been a huge fan. I love Nicole Richie for that, though.
I still like her.
Paris?
I like them both.
I like Nicole. Well, I mean, I don't really follow either of them. When I see Nicole Richie on something, I'll be like, oh, look, good for her. Like, she was on, like, a fashion show, right?
I'm pretty sure. And she had her own clothing line for a while.
She did. She did.
Yeah.
And Nicole Fox, winner of the petite season of America's Next Top Model, was like the face of it. Just a little fun fact.
I didn't remember that.
The red-haired girl? The one with the bloody
eyeball? Yeah, I didn't know that was her name.
Oh, Nicole Fox, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't
know. I'm a fan. I watched...
Oh, I loved America's Next Top Model. I stopped after, like, season 9, though, because I just...
I stopped after they changed the format and fired everybody. Yeah. And so I was like, I'm not coming back. And then I tried the newer season because Tyra came back, because there was, like, a season with Rita Ora. I'm like, fuck that. And then yeah, Tyra's back.
I don't understand what Rita Ora does.
I don't either. They just keep trying to make her happen.
I know
She's
that
like
she fetch. Writes music. She's like fetch.
It's just not going
to
happen.
Stop trying to make
they keep, it happen. Her and Tinashe, they keep trying to make it happen, and it is not happening, guys. I'm sorry. Just write music. Do something in the background. You're not the face of anything, honey.
You're not an influencer.
Love you.
Yeah.
Sorry, I don't love you. I don't really know who you are. I'm sorry, but have a nice life.
Wow.
Going forward, you wanted to talk about Instagram?
No.
It just says Instagram, all caps, most of anyone this year.
Oh, I'm making notes on what to post.
Oh, shit. Grammys. So I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Instagram. So I bolded things and I added things. I do want to talk about... This is something that I struggle with like my own fears for anxiety. Like I have triggers about things and sex trade is one of them. Like mm-hmm. I'm always scared my kids are going to be kidnapped. And we've talked about this before. I don't need to get into it again. It makes me sound crazy. There was an article posted that a girl in Houston, she's 15 years old. She committed suicide because at 13 years old, she was drugged and introduced into like the sex trade in Houston. Her parents did eventually get her back, but she was already addicted to drugs at that point, and she kept escaping to go back to her pimp. I forget the name of what they called him in the her abuser, I think is what he was essentially a pimp. And so 2 years after they actually rescued her, I don't know if it was it because they couldn't get her help or if they just it wasn't a good environment for her to stay around, but she ended up committing suicide. Like she barricaded the bathroom door, and now the parents in Houston, of course, they're Latino. Are like suing the local police to make them more accountable. They're trying to, in fact, change. So they're making them more accountable for the sex trade now. And they're also actively searching for a pimp to put him behind bars because they want to accuse him of her death.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
that
also,
poor child.
Everyone's doing the 10 and 10, like 10 year, the decade posts on social media. Mm-hmm. And I got in on it this morning because I had a funny picture of me and Daniel skydiving and then me and Daniel painting the house. And it's mm-hmm. the same level of enthusiasm. So I did it like that. But my sister, Amanda, posted that she doesn't have pictures from 10 years ago, but she was probably in a bar snorting something or smoking something around people that really didn't care about her. And so now she's like in charge of her own health and sober and happy. And I was like, love this. This is the best decade thing I've seen.
I saw the picture. He looks so underwhelmed.
Me?
No, your husband.
Oh, he always looks like that. He doesn't smile.
And you're over here like cheesing it.
Yeah,
huge.
I have like the biggest mouth open smile.
You went skydiving?
Yeah.
Oh my God. How was it?
I want to go again.
That sounds so scary.
It was amazing.
Were you strapped to somebody?
Yeah. I went tandem.
Okay. Like, like, what does it feel like falling? Like when you're dreaming and you wake up and you're falling, is
no.
it like that?
Mm-mm. You feel like you're flying. You don't feel like you're falling. And that was the most, that was what I was scared about the most. Cause there's a video and I'll show you in our private time I recorded Daniel's jump. Right. Uh-huh. And so he was like, my girlfriend's back there. Cause we're all in the plane together. And they got a shot of me and I look like checked out because I was like, I can't believe I'm gonna jump out of the fucking plane. Because every couple seconds you're like, oh, we're high enough, and then like, no, you're not, because you jump at like 14,000 something feet, you have to. And so like I was like, oh, I can't do this, and I was like gonna back out, and then at the last minute like I just did it. So but you feel like you're flying, you don't feel like you're falling. Mm-hmm. So when you're falling, you're just literally like, I can't explain it, but it doesn't feel like a roller coaster. It doesn't feel like you're falling. You see birds around you. Like you can see the curvature of the earth. Yeah. Cause we went at dusk. So like it was dark on the ground, but we were so high up that it was still bright. And you can actually see like the formation of the earth. It's incredible. It's really, really amazing.
That sounds really scary.
It's not scary. And then when they open the chute, it feels even more like you're flying. Because you fall for about... You fall a certain distance, and then they open the chute. Uh-huh. And then you just, like, coast beautifully down. It's amazing.
Does that hurt when you land?
Not at all. Not at all. I thought it was going to be, like, this impact, and it's not. You just, like, slide onto the ground. It's so weird.
That is weird.
If you've not been skydiving, anything that you can imagine is not what it feels like.
I knew somebody who did skydiving.
And I was scared too, and I had the best time. It was cathartic.
I don't know if I ever could.
You should.
I'm good.
You should try it. It's really amazing. Like, I think
people die.
I saw a 90-year-old man crash into the woods around the field, got up and got back on the plane and went back up by himself. Like, he was a seasoned skydiver. I saw an 8-month pregnant woman in a purple jumpsuit. I'll never forget it because I couldn't believe she was skydiving solo pregnant, but she was. Yeah.
Is that legal?
Yeah.
That's not endangerment?
Mm-mm, it's completely safe. That's the harness is not anywhere that would, like...
But no, like, if you were to, land bad, the baby could die.
Sure, but the chances of that happening are so slim.
I don't know. I don't trust the odds.
It was very, very good. If you've ever been interested, it's worth it. You should try it.
I knew somebody who was into skydiving, though, and he did those wingsuits.
I don't know what that is.
It's like you're like a flying squirrel. Like, it's like a suit you wear, and then you have like wings.
Oh my God, yeah.
And then you like zoom across shit.
I'm into it.
Like people like die constantly doing that one because...
I'm a huge risk taker.
You can't tandem it.
It's fine.
Because like you...
But I'm sure you have to do like the 8 tandems to get to that point. You have to do so many tandems before they'll even let you do it on your own.
I think you have to do, like, hundreds of solo normal ones before they allow you to do.
So you're pretty seasoned by the time you do it.
But still, like, you... Like, people, like, crash into mountains and die immediately. Because the impact, you're going so fast.
Yeah.
Like, it's scary. It's so scary.
I want to try bungee jumping. I want to try spelunking. Like, I love all of that extreme adrenaline running shit. Like, no. I'm into it.
I'm not a risk taker.
But I don't like motorcycles. I'm not into motorcycles.
I'll fall out of the sky.
I had a high school teacher that got hit by a semi.
Oh, shit.
He'd been motorcycling for years. He was amazing at it. And he was a safe driver. And then at, like, the age of 62, Mr. Teft, my human anatomy teacher, he had to have both legs amputated. He was crushed by the semi because the semi was, like, the guy was, like, tired.
Oh, my God.
And didn't see him and, like, clipped him.
Oh my God. Just clipped him.
So I don't do motorcycles. I don't like that.
That's terrible.
But I'll bungee jump in a heartbeat.
All right. Moving on.
Let's talk about Miss Tay-Tay.
Okay, so Taylor Swift is spinning this narrative, and I don't know...
a lot of feelings about it.
How to feel about it. Because she's alleging that Scooter Braun and the other guy who's in charge of Big Machine Records... are not allowing her to... Because she's getting, like, a Lifetime Achievement Award or something at, like, the American Music Awards.
Yeah, that's so stupid to me.
Why?
I don't know. I mean, I know she's done a lot, but I just, like... First of all, I listened to her album this year.
Uh-huh.
What's the one with,
Brandon Urie?
What?
Me?
No. The one before this one that she came out with.
1989?
Yeah.
That was a good album.
Loved that one. That one was great. That was her first crossover, right?
No.
No? Her first full-length crossover
was
album.
Was Red. Wasn't it Red?
No.
It was the one with Shake It Off. This wasn't Shake It Off. This was Blank Space.
Yes. Okay, yeah. So her second crossover album, I thought it was wonderful. I thought it was great. I thought it was well-produced. I listened to it all the time. Uh-huh. Loved it. Loved everything out of it. Loved her collab with Kendrick Lamar. Loved it. This album, I thought, was not, like, either I don't think I'm a Swiftie.
I'm not.
I
can't deny she has some bops.
Yeah, no, her music is totally catchy, but I'm not a Swiftie, and I don't understand how she's getting the Lifetime Achievement Award. I don't think she's done that much to push the boundaries in music. I think she's talented, I love her voice, it's very unique and different. Her style of music I really like too, but I don't know that she's really... When I think artist of the decade or lifetime achievement, like, I want to know that you've done some new weird shit. And to me, I just feel like Ariana Grande with these last two albums, I absolutely love Thank You Next. And I liked Sweetener. It was okay. But Thank You Next was so cool. Like, that album was so weird. Val says listening to her songs on that album make her feel like she has ADHD because she goes into all these different places and she's trying new things. And I don't know. I don't know about her.
I would never give Ariana Grande a Lifetime Achievement Award. Before Taylor Swift, at least. Because Taylor Swift, I agree with what you're saying in terms of her not pushing boundaries, but she did change the face of being an independent artist. And how much you can achieve as an independent artist.
Oh, okay. I guess I didn't think about that because I'm thinking about music.
She inspired tons of girls to learn guitar and influenced in that way. Oh, like Kacey Musgraves was inspired by her and a bunch of other people. Like, she's done her thing. It's just not...
If you're not a Swiftie, you don't know those things, and I'm not a Swiftie.
I'm not a Swiftie either, though, and I recognize it. Like, I don't like her as a person based off of what I've seen. And I don't know whose side to be on in this situation either. That we're about to touch on. But I can't deny her talent.
No, she's talented.
I can't deny her achievements, and I can't deny that she can write a catchy fucking song.
No,
I agree. So, I mean, I understand it. I'm not necessarily going to support it, but yeah. I understand why she is getting this award because she has earned it to certain degrees.
Lifetime achievement, though?
Yeah, I mean, Miss Thing's been in the business for what, 15 years?
Is she 30?
She's about to be.
Yeah, okay.
She's been around for a minute. So, like, half of her life, she's been performing.
I guess, yeah.
It's just, I don't concede.
I don't know. I don't find her music to be that
influential.
I don't.
It's always current. It's never forward thinking like Missy was or Britney was.
No, and I even
or Madonna.
I even think with Ariana's latest album, it's really forward thinking. It's definitely unlike anything I've ever heard. I actually think I might like this better than Demi's last album, and it hurts me to say that. It hurts me.
Mm-hmm.
But like, it's so, I don't know. I don't.
No, I mean, sometimes your faves put out a stinker. Love Madonna to death. I cannot get on board with Madame X.
Yeah, the last two from Christina Aguilera.
Oh my God.
Broke my heart.
Lotus was awful. Bionic was trash.
Yeah, and this last one that she really...
Whoa, there's another one?
She released like 7 songs.
Was like an EP?
Yeah. Demi Lovato was on it too. And
oh.
It felt like they were trying too
hard. But no, like, even with Britney Spears, Glory... No, was it Glory? Not Glory. Glory was good. Uh-uh. It was Britney Jean. Britney Jean was trash.
Yeah.
But it was also produced by will.i.am, so I can't be surprised because he's a thief.
Yeah.
But your faves... I mean, that doesn't mean they're not your faves. Demi will still always have a special
place. Oh my God, yes. Because women with powerhouse voices are very important to me.
But regardless, the situation that's unfolding currently is Taylor made a post on Tumblr essentially alleging that... Scooter Braun and the head of Big Machine Records, who now own like all of her old music, are saying she is not allowed to perform her classic songs of like from like her early days.
And it's important because with that award,
Lifetime Achievement,
she wanted to play a melody of her songs, and that makes sense to me.
And they're saying she can't. And also, she's doing a Netflix documentary.
And they're saying
she can't
use her music for that.
As well. And so they came out and said, oh, that's not true. We never said this, blah, 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 blah. But essentially, her reasoning behind it was saying this is considered doing a re-recording of her music, which she is allowed to do at a certain point. So she
November
can get
2020.
She can re-record all of her old music so she can own the rights to that music again, which I don't understand, but music copyright is something I never really got into, but whatever, she can get the rights to her music
it's
back.
It's not going to be exactly the same though. She's going to change it.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
But like, I mean, if her voice sounds different than 15 years ago, so that in and of itself is going to be different.
I don't know. This might be, so it could be a few things. Mari and I don't know how we feel. We're just,
well, finish telling what's happening.
Oh, where did you leave off?
Well, I left off with her saying all of this.
Okay. People have come out after she posted that, like right when she posted the Tumblr thing to Instagram, Justin Bieber spoke up and he actually tagged in the article saying that, what's his record? His record label?
A Big Machine?
No. Big Machine was hers. Scooter Braun, his people that bought it.
That's Big Machine
Records.
Right.
He owns it, but like he had one of his own. It now falls under that umbrella.
Right. Well, whatever it is.
Whatever it is. His main company that bought out Big Machine and the catalog to Taylor Swift, Everything Before Lover. There was an article released saying that they never said that. They weren't going to come out and stop her from playing at the award ceremony. I don't remember if it said anything about Netflix. But I know this specifically, it was about the awards ceremony, and that's what the statement said. After that, when it's, of course, Justin Bieber got involved, Justice Bieber.
Stop.
The Office is so big in my brain right now.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
After Justin Bieber said that. So, the Swifties, is that what they're called?
Yeah.
Her fan group. They started going after Scooter Braun, but not just Scooter Braun, like the actual record company. They had to shut down their offices for 2 days because employees didn't feel safe, which... If you're familiar with tribes of fans like the Bay Hive, I mean, they will literally eviscerate you. Swifties are just as powerful.
Yeah.
Levotics are powerful. Like, everybody.
They will call in bomb threats. They will threaten the lives of your family.
Which they did. They called and had death threats to Scooter, his wife, and his children.
Yeah.
Which I think is way too far.
That is so fucking
far. I think the whole thing is too far. And I'll get to that in a second. So basically, Scooter released a statement saying that, like, I don't know if this is a narrative. I hope this isn't actually what you've been told. If it is, I've tried to contact you in the last 3 days to sit down and talk about it and resolve it quietly and not at the expense of, like, the death threats to my family. So I hope to hear from you soon.
Yeah. Well, no, he said, I've tried like 6 times and every time it's been denied.
Yeah.
So this is the only way I think I can communicate to you openly.
Yeah.
So please reach out to me so we can come to some sort of agreement.
Yeah.
However, this, like, the company that bought it also did something really shady before Scooter Braun released this.
Mm-hmm.
And they said...
Oh, I didn't know about this.
They said that Taylor is allowed to perform her music at the American Music Awards. They've gotten with Dick Clark Productions and made an agreement.
Yeah.
So she can perform her music without any issue and not, without any cost or whatever.
Right.
And then Dick Clark Productions came out and said, we have spoken to nobody about this.
Yeah.
Know nothing of this. We are not commenting on the situation. If you have any questions about the situation... see the people involved because we have nothing to do with it.
So they
fucking lied. Mm. So that's what's also making me not certain whose side to be on about this, because Scooter Braun could just be trying to save face and also cover his family.
Or maybe Scooter Braun is not aware of the assholes working behind the scenes that got Taylor's catalog.
But he has Taylor's catalog. He's the head of the assholes.
He is the head of the assholes, but oftentimes lawyers will act in the best interest of the client and not even discuss things with them.
I doubt it's even lawyers. I think there's another man involved.
This is a legal thing.
No, there's another man
Taylor,
involved.
Legally, Taylor cannot... If this is true, legally, Taylor cannot perform her music.
Is his name like Scott Bruschetta or something like that?
Scott Bruschetta? I think so, but...
He's the head of the record label.
Okay.
And he's
what
the
I'm
one
saying
who's
is
been...
it's very possible Scooter Braun doesn't even know that... I'm saying that it's possible. Is it possible? I don't know, but it is possible. Maybe he doesn't know the extent of what's been said or what's been worked out. People are trying to make decisions and save face, because here's the thing is Taylor pissed off a lot of people when she released her first statement, which I was here for.
Yeah.
Good for you. Like, stand up for yourself. I'm all about that. But I think this is the backlash from it. But I also feel as though, like, I understand how it's important to stand up for yourself as a woman, especially in the entertainment industry.
Yep.
But I feel like calling hordes of your fans, knowing how immature these people can be, and calling death threats... Like, knowing that your fans gave death threats and you've said nothing about it, you haven't asked your fans to back off.
Yeah.
You haven't asked them to behave nice. Like, nothing. You're doing what Trump did. That's how I feel about it.
Mm-hmm.
You're responsible for what you put out there because you have this huge platform. And when they started doing those things, you should have asked them to stop.
You should have intervened.
Even if they didn't stop... You should have asked them to stop.
Yeah. Say, or I don't condone this.
And it's almost like she's, and it almost feels like because she didn't, it almost feels like she's like, yeah, look what I can do.
Yeah.
And I don't like that. Like, as a woman, I don't like that.
She's flexing
and I flex when it's appropriate, but not flex at the death threats are not okay. And people are really crazy when it comes to their favorite stalkers. You don't know if someone actually was probably going to go through with it. Like, you don't know.
You don't know. Some of these kids are crazy.
And those children have nothing to do with what their father did to you. His wife, well, she's involved in the industry too, so I kind of understand that. But it's not okay for death threats, and you should have stopped it. You should have stopped it. Or tried to stop it, because I'm sure you can't stop it. But if something were to actually happen to those children, she would
be... It's on her.
Yeah, it's completely her responsibility, and she would be devastated.
I'm sure.
But she's a little bit, like... born on third base, thought she hit a triple type of person. That's how I feel about Taylor Swift.
I don't know what the fuck that means, but sure.
The people who think they're born on third base. People who are born on, they were born on third base, meaning they had all of the privileges in the world handed to them, but think that they hit a triple. So they believe that.
They got themselves there?
Yeah. And they kind of didn't. They were born on third base. I feel that way about her. I know her parents have money. She didn't really have to struggle. She didn't really have to come up. Then there's that whole rumor about, like, her dad bought all of her first albums.
What?
Yeah. Have you heard that?
No.
Yeah. So her very first album that she released with Big Machine Records, there's this big rumor about, and if it's not true, it's terrible. Like, nobody should say this, but there's always a grain of truth in every rumor that you hear. There's always some grain of truth. There is a rumor that her dad bought a huge portion of her very first album and they're sitting in a storage unit somewhere.
Oh.
And that's how she got, like, up on the charts, that got people to listen to the music. So there's that rumor. A little bit.
Or it can also just be somebody trying to discredit her achievement.
Well, that's very true. That's why I said it's a rumor. I don't know. Maybe her dad bought a portion of them to celebrate and then someone spun it. But, like, I do kind of feel like, I don't know. I don't like it. I don't like how she handled it. I don't like how he handled it.
I just think it's a messy situation.
And again, I go back to the very beginning. This is Big Machine Records' fault. They're the ones that kept you from buying back your music. They're the ones that sold the company trying to keep you on because it would leverage their business. I understand that you have an issue with Scooter Braun, but he's not the one that caused it. He saw a business opportunity and was like, fuck yeah, I want Taylor Swift's albums. Mm-hmm. But who's the asshole that put them up for sale in the first place?
Yeah.
That your issue is with him. I don't know. Like, I don't know. I don't know how to feel about this, but I have a lot of opinions about it.
Definitely.
I don't like it, though.
Now, moving on, you had some of your own icebreakers that you added in here as well.
Yes, Madeline watched Xenon and had a very strong reaction to it.
I love it so much.
Maddie was like, oh my god, their clothes are so cute. And I was like, yes, bitch, yes. That's how I felt, too. And then when she got grounded to Earth, Madeline took it so hard. She was like, how could she leave the only home she's ever known? My daughter is six. She's so sensitive. And I'm like, I passed on the empath gene. Like, it's right there. So it was really, she had a very strong reaction and loved it.
I'm so glad.
Loved it. She's been rewatching, like, the music on YouTube.
Aww.
It's so cute.
I love Supernova
Girl. Xenon is my favorite. It's so good.
Same.
She also liked Gotta Kick It Up. I watched it this morning, but I had her watch it this week. She's into dance, so that's really cool. I've been binging Lemonade Mouth as often as I can.
Is it a series?
No, it's a movie.
You've just been watching it over and over?
Over and over and over again. And if I don't have time to watch it from beginning to end, I will watch the videos from the original Disney Channel. Remember they used to play music videos as their commercials? I've been watching those on YouTube.
Oh, work.
I love it so much. And then there's some YouTube drama that, like, I just happen to go down a hole of. Trisha Paytas is involved with, like, with smaller... Well, that's not fair because Gabby DiMartino is not really small, but, like, other... YouTubers, they're feuding over nothing. But basically what's happening, even though Trisha is the person involved in all the dramas, she causes all the dramas and she has all the dramas.
I'm not a fan.
A lot of people are turning against Gabby Hanna.
Oh.
She's a smaller influencer, but people are coming out with, like, all her manipulative bullshit. She DM'd private messages to a fan, a 15-year-old fan, to discredit Jesse Smiles. And that fan, like, felt uncomfortable. It was weird, but she was like, okay, kept getting the information and then contacted someone who would get in touch with Jesse Smiles. And she was like, look, I have all this on my Instagram DMs. This is what Gabby Hanna sent me. And she sent it all to Jesse Smiles. And Jesse Smiles was like, that's it. Like, we are no longer friends. We haven't been friends. I've never addressed it. I'm going to address it now. And so, like, she put her on blast and she put all of the live screen of the Instagram messages on there. She's like, pause it and read it. This woman told her my private information about, like, my anxiety drugs and, like, when I was raped and all, like, it was crazy. It was crazy.
I know who neither of these girls are.
Jesse Smiles was a big Viner.
What she
was
like?
A huge Viner. She is, she's Hispanic, but she doesn't look Hispanic. She's Cuban, I think. She's from Miami.
Oh.
Yeah.
And I can show you a picture. The other girl?
Gabby Hanna, I've never watched her videos. I don't know. I know of her because she's of that younger influencer. And I watched, like, one or two of those. Like, and I'm really into Adeline.
She IM'd a 15-year-old fan.
Mm-hmm.
Just randomly?
She says something because Trisha posted a comment about Gabby Hanna And the fan was like, don't forget, we all know that Gabby Hanna chose to be friends with Jesse Smiles' rapist instead of Jesse Smiles. And Gabby, not Gabby, Gabby Hanna.
I've never seen her a day in my life.
Yeah, who, Jesse Smiles?
Wait, Curtis Laporte, who is he?
I have no idea.
Is that her ex-boyfriend? Is that the
rapist? Maybe, yeah.
I know Curtis Laporte, but of him being a rapist. Okay.
Yeah. So Jesse Smiles is the girl that he raped.
Oh,
yeah. Shit. And then Gabby Hanna, who was supposed to be her best friend, stayed friends with him after. Wow. After this whole thing happened. And so Gabby Hanna, that fan said it. She messaged her privately and she's like, you have no idea how manipulative Jesse is and how terrible she is and X, Y, and Z. And then started sending her old text messages to show, to like discredit Jesse. But the messages weren't in anything that would like discredit her.
What is I recognize her nose.
Who?
Gabby Hanna. Who is she? What is she in?
She's an influencer. I don't know. I don't know that she's in anything. She's not an actress.
I don't know. But that's awful.
She looks like another small actor.
She looks like somebody.
Yeah. Anyway, it's just, I got down this hole because I came across it. Because Jesse Smiles doesn't post that often, but when she does, I watch it because she's really funny.
Mm-hmm.
I like her a lot. But that's it. Mine are nowhere near as like entertaining as Mario's. That's just the hole. That's just the hole I've been down this week, laying in the bed with crippling depression.
All right.
Alrighty.
Did you want to talk about your perfume?
Yes.
Do you have it here?
It's in the car.
Okay.
Because I took it.
I thought nothing was in the car.
No,
nothing is in the car.
Old car.
Oh, okay. Are you gonna bring that up? Or is that gonna be a silver lining?
I can bring it up. I'll bring it up. A silver lining.
Okay. Ray of light.
Ray of light. Thank you. I love perfume. I love high-end perfumes. It's like my Coach bag obsession.
Mm-hmm.
And is this where it records from?
I don't know. Okay. Well, it's just I feel like
it's equidistant.
We were a little bit quiet last episode.
So okay. Sorry.
I think there's microphones here and here.
Oh, well, then it's perfect.
Okay.
So Kim Kardashian releases perfumes all the time. I actually really like the one with her naked body on it. It's like her dimensions. Have you seen that?
No, I just like the peach one.
It's so cool. It's so...
The peach is such a cute packaging.
I love...
The Dollar Tree knocked it off.
Oh, yeah.
I was tempted to buy just the Dollar Tree one because so cute.
She released a new perfume with her sister's... Chloe and Courtney, and it's the diamond collection, and she has a white diamond, mm-hmm. and Courtney has a yellow diamond, and who's the other one?
Chloe
has a pink diamond, and I came.
What about blue diamond?
They didn't do it. There's only three sisters.
They have
four she only sisters. Did it with her like 100% biological sisters.
Fuck everybody else.
I guess. I don't know. She did one with Kylie already.
But what about
Kylie was the lips.
Or what about
Kendall? She's not into all that.
Nobody likes Kendall, right?
No, Kendall doesn't collab.
Why?
I don't know. She doesn't collab with
her. You can make fucking money.
I don't know. She doesn't need it. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I bought the yellow diamond one.
And she loves it.
And it smells so good. It makes me so happy. And it's perfume. And it's like third world shit. I can't wait to show Mario. I'll show you when you leave.
Why is it third world?
Because it's like it's first world shit is what I'm saying. Like, oh my God, a perfume. Like, way to go. But I really do love perfumes. And I'm trying to take care of myself and not push my own stuff aside.
I'm glad.
It smells so good. And I had a panic attack for my best friend. She's the only person that's seen me have a panic attack besides my husband, and it's super embarrassing.
It shouldn't be embarrassing, girl.
But it is, because I have a problem with emotions.
Kim, and Kim is not judging you. Kim was just concerned.
It's not. Kim.
What?
Oh, hold on. Kim is not the issue. I don't like emotions.
Oh, okay.
What'd you call me? INTJ.
INTJ?
I'm an intage.
Inch.
Inch. Inch, bitch. Okay, sorry.
Now, you also had something in here about Jaclyn Hill.
Jaclyn Hill. She's still getting hate.
I mean, I'm not surprised.
I want it to stop is what I'm saying. Like, let a bitch breathe. She's gotten hate for her weight. It's not even just the lipstick, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's everything. Like, her weight. Her, like, emotion.
Did she gain weight?
Yeah. She's gained like 30 pounds. Have you not seen pictures of her at the E's People's Choice?
No.
Oh my God. Here's the thing. She's still beautiful to me. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying like it's a weight gain. She's gained a lot of weight and she's getting shit about it. And she tries to make jokes, and she's like, "I sweatpants are all that fit me right now." Like, she'll say stuff like that.
This was where?
Let me see. Turn around. Which one are you looking at? With the red hair?
No. I just looked up Jaclyn Hill, E! People's Choice.
Yeah.
Should I put an exclamation point?
No. So ridiculous. It can't be that sensitive.
I don't know. Nothing's coming up.
Hold on.
She had red hair?
Yeah. She put on a wig. Hold on. Oh, the images aren't coming up.
All I think of whenever somebody brings something up like this to me, is from Family Guy.
What?
And Sue's like, oh, and she has gotten fat.
It's so mean. All right, let's see. Let's see if they'll show a good picture. Do you see that?
She looks fine. What are they talking about?
No, her chest is huge. She's normally very thin. She's a thick girl, but she's...
Work. No, she looks amazing. Yeah, no, I see it. I see the tits. Like, she went from, like, a C to a D. But
that's
like,
the weight gain, is what I'm telling you.
Who cares? She looks amazing.
But that's what
people are giving her shit for that?
Look, yeah. Look. See that? All that right there?
Yes.
Yeah. Look, her face is definitely rounder, too. Here's the thing. She still looks beautiful. But people are like, oh, you're so fat now. You don't care about yourself. Like, people are... She gets hate for breathing. You don't understand. Like, if you want to throw shade because of her hairy lipsticks, I'm kind of... Like, I get it. She needs to learn her lesson. But she gets shit for everything. And her weight gain has been... She even addressed it in, like, one of her last videos.
She looks amazing.
She was like, when did it become okay for anyone to comment on a woman's weight? I'm not pregnant. I'm stressed out. My first launch failed. I fucked up. I didn't handle it well. I didn't handle myself as a CEO well. So I ate. Like, back the fuck off and let me eat. Like, yeah. It was a whole thing. And I'm like, she cannot breathe without someone just
criticizing her. That's the price of fame.
It's more harsh for her than other people.
Well, I think she also gives it.
But let's not forget that everybody...
By acknowledging it.
But I think... Let's not forget what happened to Michelle Phan.
That's not what happened with Michelle Phan.
Michelle Phan, failed at her cover... Was it CoverGirl?
Lancome.
She failed at that. Ipsy didn't do well. And she felt like she was failing and people were talking about her failures constantly. And she went off of YouTube. And she traveled for months, and she's just now getting into things.
The reason she left was because she was getting sued because she was selling knockoff makeup in Ipsy. And so she sold Ipsy and went off the grid. That's majorly different.
Well, I don't know. I feel like here's the thing is, we have the power of the internet.
I love Michelle Phan.
I do, too.
Her Barbie makeup was so crazy.
Oh, my God, yes.
I loved that one.
But, with the power of the internet, the power of a platform,
what happened to Promise Fan?
I don't know.
You know who that is, right?
No.
Her cousin.
I have no idea.
The one who does, the crazy transformations to, Disney characters?
Oh, yes. Oh, I have no idea.
Is she alive?
I thought you said Promise Fan, F-A-N.
No, her...
But, fam. Fawn. No, I get it. Yeah, I
Michelle
get it.
Michelle Fawn, Promise Fawn.
Well, I had to think about it, but yeah. But, just because you can say a mean comment...
Doesn't mean you should.
And if a bitch gains a little bit of weight,
Let her live.
Let her live. Sometimes you need to eat the whole pizza.
Mm-hmm. Helps you. It's good for the soul.
Gluten hurts my stomach, but I had a sandwich today.
I didn't think about that.
Well, I thought I made a conscious decision.
Oh, okay, girl.
Because I was like, I'm only going to have corn tortillas. I had to be really careful about how much I eat because I can eat it in small quantities.
Oh, okay.
But, it's not okay to make fun of people just because you don't like them. Don't watch them.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying? Maybe you're not a Jaclyn Hill fan. Do you watch her videos?
No.
Do you leave mean comments?
Yes. No, I'm totally joking.
My heart
don't.
Just shattered.
I do not. I do
that
not. I'm not that kind of girl.
Dr. Phil said something because I've been listening to, he did an investigative one podcast. Mm-hmm. And he was like... He said, if you knew how little people actually thought about you, you'd stop thinking about it too. And that hit me really hard. And then the other one he said was people who talk shit about you aren't a true representative of your fan base because those people are sitting in their room, writing mean comments and not experiencing the world and what you have to offer. And if people don't like you, then they just don't like you and they don't pay attention to you. Yeah. So, like, the person...
That's how I'm a Dr. Phil. I don't pay attention to him.
Sure.
Except but, like, when my friend rings her up constantly.
Listen. But that's the point, right? Like, if someone's talking shit about you, they're putting that much effort into, like, being so fucking negative. They're not experiencing the world. Therefore, they can't experience what you're bringing into the world. Therefore, they cannot be a part of your fan base.
Yeah.
And then people who don't like you just don't watch you or don't pay attention to you. I don't know. I just, like, let the bitch live, damn it.
I'm just thinking of when you told me about the Chris Watts thing.
Oh, my God, it was so good.
But, like, she was so excited. I
devoured that podcast.
And she's like, oh, my God, Dr. Phil did this amazing podcast. And my first response was...
I was like, I'm going to convince Mario to listen, and we're going to talk about it. And Mario was like, how nice for him. And I was like, oh. When Mario says... When I talk about something that Mario does not support at all, he just goes, how nice for them. And I go, okay, we're not talking about it. That's Mario shut me down. He's like, ah, bitch. Meant
to be you.
Not a toe over the fucking line. And also Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson series in it, and I'm really sad about it.
Aww. I don't know. I'd consider, like, drudging through Dr. Phil's, like, terrible voice if it was...
The Chris Watts one is good. Worth like, it. I don't think you need to listen to fill in the blanks, but, like, Chris Watts
is what it's called?
Yeah. I went over to talk to Mario about it. He was like, he's not a fucking doctor. And I was like, okay, I'm
he's
sorry.
He's not.
I was like, but it's really good. He's like, it doesn't matter. I don't like it. He's not a fucking doctor. And I was like, oh my God, okay, I'm so sorry.
I didn't
like,
say that. Work? I no, did not say fucking
face,
at work.
Your face, though, said fucking. And also, why is this fucking bitch talking to me about this fucking man I don't
I
like?
I never that. Think that about you.
No, I know. But oh my God. Face does. Your face does.
I can't, that's just my face.
No, it's fine. I like it. It keeps me in line.
No, so that makes me more people. Self-conscious about what happened at work.
Oh, so. You want to talk about it now? I was going to bring it up in Ray of Light.
Is that a ray of light? Because yes. I legit could not focus for the rest of the day.
I'm going to bring no, ray of light. It's a ray of light because you're taking it the wrong way.
Well, no.
You are. I'm so sad right now.
Why?
That was such like a cool moment.
It was a cool moment, but I wasn't ready for it. I have to be emotionally prepared for that shit. And I was just like,
I'm done with that. We're not emotionally preparing you anymore. We're going to talk about ray light because it is a ray light.
Oh my God.
It is a ray light.
So, holy shit, we've talked for an hour.
Let's do this. Gotta kick it up.
We're going to do a really quick review of Gotta Kick It Up and why it was so important to us growing up.
Absolutely. And Mario and I are how many years apart? I always forget.
Enough. No, yeah. Six
years apart. So that's pretty significant in a childhood.
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, because when you're six, I'm 12. That's a big deal. That's a gap right there.
But I was always a very old soul, so.
Yeah, but it's still, yeah, okay. So gotta kick it up.
We have very similar references.
We do.
Anyway, so this is in honor of Disney Plus launching, because mm-hmm. we're such big fans, and it has all the DCOMs, and we love all the Disney Channel original movies.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, well, we should review something, like, just for the sake of reviewing it. And it's like, we've already talked about Xenon, like twice.
Xenon's the cutest so much.
And so I was like, well, let's pick a different movie. And she's like, well, you pick something. She's like, I'm terrible at picking something. You pick something. And she's like, no, I don't want to. It's like, fine, I gotta kick it up.
And I was like, great, love it. Haven't watched it yet since it's been on Disney Plus.
Same. So I just took notes as I watched it. I don't know. There were some things I had, like questions I had.
Now that you're watching it as an adult.
As an adult, exactly. So I will say the teacher looks just like Shelley Long.
It's not Shelley Long, though.
But I thought it was Shelley Long as a
For
child.
For a long time. I think a lot of people did.
I thought it was. She sounds like her. She sounds like
yeah,
her.
Yeah, I guess a little bit. I feel like I could distinguish their voices, but I also think I'm good at that.
I'm not. I'm terrible
like
at
when
that.
People think that Georgia Hardstark and Karen Kilgariff sound alike, and I'm like,
I
how?
Thought that for the first
not me
75 episodes of
I was like,
Murder.
Oh my God, they sound so different. So I'm good at voices.
Well, they sound different in how they talk
mm-mm.
instead of how they sound. They have very similar voices.
Mm-mm.
And so I can tell by, oh, somebody said it this way. Oh, that was Georgia.
Nope. I can hear the difference in their voices, but I also have sisters who are twins.
Oh, there you go.
So that could be it.
There you go. But anyway, I don't know. Is this just me? But ever since I was a child, I always thought Daisy gave off like major lesbian vibes.
Daisy?
Fuente?
No.
Salinas? The main girl?
No.
I always got that off of her.
She had a boyfriend.
And? I had a girlfriend. That doesn't mean shit.
I cannot imagine you with a girlfriend.
It was weird.
The conversations we have in my bedroom.
But anyway, I always got major lesbian vibes off her.
It's not something that I got instantly from her, but I'll think about it and I'll let you know at the end of this review.
Oh, okay. I also pointed out that, so if you don't know the premise of this movie, by the way, it is set in like a poor Latino school, like in California.
Probably a border town.
Probably, very near. And, well, yeah, because Marisol's grandma.
Yeah.
But anyway.
Yep.
Anyway, this teacher starts, and she's a complete bitch to everybody at first.
Including her students.
Including her students. And she ends up becoming the dance teacher, or the dance teacher?
Yeah, coach. Dance coach. Yeah.
The dance coach. And, like, the main girls are a bunch of Latina girls from, like, different backgrounds. They're not really different backgrounds. They're all lower class, but they have different experiences in life and have different aspirations.
And I don't think that they were all Central American either.
Do you not?
No, I don't. Well,
I thought they were all,
let me,
like,
stop. I don't think that they were all Mexican, but they were definitely Mexican, Central American.
Definitely.
And those all have different ways of growing up.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I agree on that. They're all Latina, though.
Right. They're all Latina, but everyone thinks that we're all the same. Mario and I did not even eat the same foods growing up.
Jackie thought both me and Kim were Mexican.
No, and Kim is Guatemalan.
Yeah. It's just like...
It's very different.
No, it is very different.
And people don't realize that. But you both look Asian, so it's fine.
I do not.
You do.
So...
Please continue with our anti-racist comments.
So all of these girls come from different, like, ethnic backgrounds, but they're all Latina. And it's just them and, like, their plights and trying to become a good dance group.
And they all have different reasons for being a dance. Some people want to go to college. Some people are trying to get out of detention. Some people just want something to do. So they're not all in there, like, gung-ho about actually competing and dancing.
Absolutely. And, like, the teacher has so much baggage. Like, so much. And I forgot how much baggage she had until I watched this again.
She was kind of the child.
She was.
Yeah.
Because, like, these kids were ready to go. And mind you, they're supposed to be, like, 13.
Yeah, they all look like they're 40.
They're all, like, 23 going on 25. Yeah. Like,
oh, and America Ferrera's in there.
Oh, yeah, Baby Ugly Betty. She's so cute in it.
Or your sister had the traveling pants. For those of you who didn't watch Ugly Betty.
I know her as Ugly Betty. I think I referred to her 3 times as Baby Ugly Betty in here.
You sure did. I saw it and I couldn't stop laughing. I love reading Mario's docket shit. Like, it sets the tone for today's episode. Like, I'm just going to start posting the dockets.
I mean...
They're pretty funny.
Now, I did get a lot of Sister Act 2 parallels on this movie.
Yes.
Like, when she first walks into the classroom.
Yes.
And they're, like, performing and singing and dancing and whatever.
Yes.
I was like, oh, cold beans and collard greens over here. Mm. Loved it. And then I have a note that says, Ms. Bartlett is a Juilliard dance graduate who worked at a dot-com company that is now teaching biology.
And we giggled about
what?
The fuck?
But I totally forgot that she dropped out. I totally forgot that aspect. After 2 weeks. And so on her resume, she said she attended Juilliard.
She did not graduate. Like, get fired for. Well, I guess if you were attended.
If you have another degree.
Yeah.
Then
she did say she came home and went to college.
Yeah, she went to college. So she has a degree, but still. So, like, I just had what? And then later on, I just went in. Never mind, LOL.
Because you find out later she didn't actually graduate from Juilliard.
She attended for 2 weeks, found out she wasn't good.
But we thought it was weird that someone who went to Juilliard, because they do present it as though she graduated from Juilliard.
Exactly.
And you find out later it's not. So you believe it. And then she worked for a dot-com company.
And I love, this is so
and
90s.
And then she's teaching, this, like, dot-com.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This dot-com
firm. My dot-com crashed. Company went under.
And I was like, oh. You
and then say she's the teaching biology. So we were confused. Like, what's a dance captain?
Yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah.
I was so confused, but I loved it. And I said, she's kind of a bitch, and I love it.
Yeah.
Because she was super bitchy, like,
and
half
super
the movie.
Independent, which I love.
Yes. Yes.
And she's also the voice of Megara and Hercules.
She is.
And I love
it. But she's not the singing voice.
But she is.
She's only the auditory voice. I'm pretty sure that's a different person.
No.
Google it.
Yeah.
Google it.
Will do.
Okay. We'll keep going, though. So as they go on, like, it just shows them failing at first and not being willing to come together. And it shows them become a team and learn to appreciate each other. But there's, like, a lot of really good things that this movie highlighted on that a lot of Disney movies do not highlight.
Megara singing voice, Susan Egan. That's her.
She's Rose Quartz? Oh my god.
I don't know who that is.
That's from Steven Universe. I've been trying to get you to watch it for fucking 2 years.
Excuse me, my doorbell rang. I'm gonna leave before Mario really
that was somebody honking the horn.
That was my doorbell.
And somebody's in the house. It's your children.
Yeah, it's fine.
She's back. She never left.
Susan Egan. She's the singer of Megara. She has what are they called when you get, like, honorary
degrees?
Yeah.
Doctorate?
Yeah, she has an honorary doctorate in voice.
From where?
I don't know. But I watched it. She was doing a master class.
Oh.
And the class had to perform that song.
Oh, I love that song.
Oh my
That's
God.
My favorite song from that movie.
Yeah.
Like, it's one of the 3 songs from the movie I have on my iPod.
I have the entire Hercules.
I should have the entire Achilles
even album. Even the Michael Bolton shit. I love Michael Bolton.
Girl.
Love yourself. I knew he was going to say it. Anyway, keep going. I knew he was going to say it. Anytime I like something that he hates, he's like, love yourself. And I'm like, I do.
I actually am totally indifferent to Michael Bolton. You just made it seem like it's like this trashy thing. So I was like, okay, let me go ahead and just throw it in.
It is kind of trashy, though. It's very, like, white girl. I have my moments.
I always lived, though, for that song where they perform when they're not supposed to perform. Where they start dancing, it's like da 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 da.
Yes. Okay, I was trying to figure out what song you.
And I was just like, oh my god, that's like my favorite one. I used to think of it all the time. I don't understand what the fuck they're saying now, though. Like, there's not words. Like, I don't know if it's just this version of it, but it feels like I feel like they used to say something back then.
Well, they could have taken it out.
Maybe for copyright. Maybe they didn't get
the rights for it, and they were like, okay, fuck it, we're posting it anyway. Disney Plus is happening, asshole. Like,
all the music is, and it could just be a fidelity issue. It still
sounds amazing.
I did write in here, fuck Esmeralda's parents, because she was pretty much raising her little brother.
Yeah, and I'm so glad you're bringing that up. I have an issue with it too, because here's the thing: is that does happen. Like a lot of times, the older child, I was that child, but guess what? I had a single parent.
Yeah.
Her mom and dad were both in the picture. There. The fuck is she doing raising an 8-year-old boy?
Yeah, no, and I love that Disney highlighted this, because they usually gloss over things like that.
They didn't.
And this movie showed a lot of shit. They talked about dropping out of high school. Yep. They talked about pretty much being, like, having no future because you dropped out of high school and what the consequences are. Parents that aren't there. They did not gloss over
anything. It was great. It was wonderful.
Absolutely. Like, they kind of glossed over. Yeah, absolutely. Like I feel like Chewie was in a gang, but
they Chewie was fucking hot.
He is hot. But
Chewie is hot.
Yeah. No, yeah. He's just short.
I saw him and I was like, how did I not get my panties in a twist when I was younger? Man, it's fine. I'm going to look him up right now. Go ahead.
He probably does. See, last episode, she completely dogged out Cheyenne, but I cut it from the episode out of respect. but she's going to dog this man too, I'm sure.
Who?
You.
Why would I dog him?
Because you dogged out Cheyenne, and Cheyenne's still hot. He looks like John Stamos.
No, he's all right. Like, I can't believe you cut it out, though.
Was
it bad?
It wasn't that it was bad. We were just like, And then it was like silence for like 30 seconds. And then, oh, you know, see, look over here. And then look at that. And it was just not a coherent conversation.
Okay.
So I was like, no, this has to go. The Laura Lee had to go. There was another thing at the very end that I had to go. I talked
too much, basically.
No, it wasn't you. It was both of us. I'm teasing. We were both just like... Side note, back to the show. Right. So anyway, like, there was this whole point where, like...
That was my stomach.
Okay. The gluten's reacting.
Yeah, that's exactly what's happening.
No, so, like, there's this point where, like, America Ferrera's character is failing math. And to pass math, she just had to calculate or count money. And I'm like, girl, what kind of remedial math are you in?
That was their way out of it, remember?
I know, but it just didn't logistically make sense. If you're failing algebra, what is counting money? You don't even have to add. You could literally just go 1, 2, 3, 4, you know? Like, you could just put all the money together and counted it, and then you didn't even have to add or do any sort of calculations. It just seemed too easy.
It was too easy.
But also, I think there is a continuity error, because they're in middle school, and she's talking to the guy about, like, the dot-com job that he's like, oh, this guy's really interested in you or whatever.
Right.
And
she's... customer service.
Right. Well, no, she was a PR person.
No, but for this position was a customer service, his head of customer service.
Oh, was it?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, she's like, well, I'm teaching ninth grade biology and I think it's going well. I was like, ninth grade?
Yeah.
You're in middle school.
No.
Middle school is through eighth grade. Ninth and above is high school.
They're in ninth grade.
They go to a middle school. They go to Marshall Middle School.
Wow.
And then she's talking about going to the High School of Performing Arts next year.
Okay, so there was a time where junior high did go to ninth grade. But
this is a middle school. This is not a junior high.
But I understand, but that could have been before they defined the name. So, I mean, I guess it is continuity, but not really.
I'm claiming it as a victory.
Because you're right. They did say Marshall Middle School. But however, they did say several times that they were in the ninth grade.
Because mm-hmm.
It's the ninth grade dance team.
Did they say ninth grade?
Yeah, they did at the beginning. What's the principal's name?
I don't know.
Whatever.
Latino guy.
Latino guy number one.
He was number four, actually.
Okay, number four. She was like, do you know that we don't have anyone for the ninth grade dance team? Do you think you can talk to her about it? And he was like, yeah, that's a good idea. I will. That's the first time ninth grade. Second time is, when they didn't have a captain, they were like, oh, Esmeralda's been waiting for this since the second grade to be on the ninth grade dance team. That's the second time. The third time was, she was like, man, when I was in the ninth grade, I got detention for like, 4 months once. So, like, you still don't beat my record. So, they mentioned this several times. I missed
all of that.
No. They mentioned several times. They were in the ninth grade. But it's just
like, this is the middle school.
Yeah, but it could be that it was, like, junior high model before we called it junior high.
Maybe.
And also, we don't know what those towns on the border are actually like as far as school goes.
True. Very true.
But way to go, because I didn't pick up on that. I was like, oh, they're in the ninth grade. But they said Marshall Middle School a million times.
But no, there is a really good, like, poignant line in this, because there's this lady, Linnell Elliott. Also, how the fuck did the teacher know that Linnell Elliott reached out to her when she wasn't there? They weren't going to tell her that they went and won third place, like all that shit.
Who's Linnell Elliott?
The lady who is trying to get her to the school.
Maybe she called her and was like, I'm really interested in your lead dancer.
Maybe, but...
But they should have explained it more, is what we're saying.
Shabunch, you told me Linnell Elliott called you. And I was like,
he's not cute anymore.
I told you she's about to dog on this man.
He's got a big forehead.
I mean, hairlines recede, girl.
They do. I mean, his face is still decent. I like that picture, but he looks like Mark Anthony.
Yeah, he's okay.
Yeah. He's not as hot as he was when he was a child. Woo! Sorry. Young adult. Well,
okay.
Sorry.
That man was clearly 24, but whatever.
Whatever. He's old enough like, to shit on, like, his face.
Oh, he's illegal. But no, like, I also felt like there was, like, a huge age difference between him and Daisy. Like, there had to have been.
Yeah.
He was, like, much older.
Yeah.
And I was like, ooh.
But I think he also kind of alluded. I mean, we know he was definitely older. Anyway, where are we in the synopsis so we can get into
at the end.
Oh, at the end. Okay.
So... I was going to say, there's this really poignant part, though, where Linnell Elliott is there,
mm-hmm.
like, for the final, and she's, like, super nervous about actually performing in front of her. And the teacher's like, this took me a really long time to learn, but there's a difference between the best and being your best. And being best is, like, very frivolous, and that's all subjective, whereas being your best knows you did the very best you can. And you need to focus on being your best versus the best, and that will get you far, and you won't want to drop out of Juilliard after 2 fucking weeks or whatever.
Yeah.
I was like, God, I wish I listened to that as a kid. Because I was always focused on being the best.
Yeah.
And never my best. And in retrospect, I regret not paying attention to that.
Yeah, but I think we were more focused on the Latino representation. Yeah. I know I was. And dance. I loved dance when I was a kid.
Same.
But, like, I don't think there'd been any prior, and I know definitely not after, until Elena of Avalor. Avalon.
Mm-hmm.
Is it Avalon or Avalor? One of the two.
Elena.
There's not a lot of Hispanic representation in Disney.
There was. You completely always forget about the Wizards of Waverly Place.
But Gotta Kick It Up happened way before that.
Yes, but Elena Avalor happened way after Wizards of Waverly Place.
That's very, very true. No, sure. I always figure out Wizard of Waverly Place because I think about them not as, like, humans. I think about them as witches.
I guess what they're Mexican witches. I know that sounds stupid.
They sure
they're
are.
They're fucking Mexican. We're
fuck
not taking
you, Jessica.
It.
They're fucking Mexican.
I was like, oh my God, they're Mexican? They're Mexican?
But
because you never hear Mexican, they didn't even mention Mexican. They're just Latina.
Yeah,
like, they're Mexican. And I was like, wow.
But the Wizards of Waverly Place to me isn't so Latino. Like, they
speak Spanish.
They do. They speak Spanish. But, like, when you watch Gotta Kick It Up, it's, like, straight.
That's very
up
true.
Culture.
Like, this is, like, lower
this
class
is a, this
Latino.
Is a, right. We're not whitewashing.
They're very whitewashing wizards. They're upper middle class. They literally have.
And they have magical powers.
Yeah. Yeah. And they literally live in New York City, like...
Yes!
In, like, a huge house.
Yes. My house was so small.
Like, this
small.
Is bigger than a brownstone.
My house was so small in New York. And we lived in the Bronx. There's a little bit more space there. But... And then, of course, Elena is very, like... It's not modern. It's, like, medieval almost. Yep. So this is, like, true... I don't know. I love it. I love it for my daughter. I don't know. It's really, really... I love the fact that kids now might watch it and all of the culture is historically still on point, right? Mm-hmm. Like, there's not a lot of difference there, but the nostalgia of it, because the way the cars looked, the way the schools looked, the way the phones looked, like, people are going to go, oh, and maybe hopefully tie a connection to there, because things really haven't changed that much for Hispanics in this country.
Absolutely.
And they're quite possibly the worst they've ever been. So, I don't know. I really like that aspect of it. And I love showing it to my daughter.
That was a great movie.
It was so good. Now, it brought me a lot of happiness this morning.
I did want to say, I forgot how abruptly this bitch ends.
Yeah.
Because it literally, like, they perform and then it just freezes and, like, they went on to nationals. So I have a lot of questions. Did Daisy get into that school? Was her mom able to afford it? How did they do at Nationals? Because apparently it must have done terribly because they didn't fucking mention anything about Nationals.
I think you're missing the point.
Did the teacher stay being a teacher or did she go to the .com job after, like, these kids went up to high school?
Mario likes everything wrapped up and I think you're missing the
point. How did she know about Linnell Elliott? And did Esmeralda's parents ever stop making her being a mother to their little brother?
That's a question I want the answer to. Yes.
Like, these are all...
The rest of it I'm fine with. Daisy overcame her fears and performed on stage. So that's all that mattered. And she applied for it. That dream was enough at that point. Okay? That, to me, is fine. She's obviously not leaving the school.
I don't know.
She's not leaving. No. She's
money. Not, this is California.
But I think the kids mean more to her.
It's like $9 for like a fucking
You're
gallon
overanalyzing
of milk.
Someone else's problem now. Like, you gotta stop, bro.
They had no money.
That's fine. I liked it. I loved it. I don't have those same questions, except for did she ever get to stop raising her
little brother.
Yeah.
One would hope.
Yeah.
But all in all, check it out if you haven't seen it. It's really a fun watch. Maybe not story-wise, because it ends abruptly, but...
For Latinos everywhere, you should watch it.
It's a really important movie from my childhood.
Me too. It definitely influenced
me. Now, I did want to end, because like they have like their whole little team slogan of Si Se Puede.
Si Se Puede, which is what I think should have been the name of the movie.
I don't think that would have got kids to come watch it.
Sure.
Because like they have to appeal to children.
I don't like Gotta Kick It Up either.
Well, they gotta kick it up. They gotta dance. They gotta let it loose.
That's a term I have never used in my life.
Well, yeah, because you weren't...
a dancer? Not a Latina? Dance.
In the 90s.
Absolutely, I was. And I was Latina.
You were? You're not
Absolutely.
Anymore?
Absolutely, yeah, apparently not. I'm not using these phrases.
But you weren't from Southwest California.
That's the one you should have led with. There you go. We found it, guys.
No, it always amazes me how different culturally. Yeah. Like, one of my very best friends, Jasmine, she is Mexican from California.
It's so different.
Compared to Mexican from New Mexico, it is so different.
I mean, Mexicans here would be so extremely different, too.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
But I did want to end on a little funny note, because Si Se Puede is their team chant.
Like their slogan.
Their slogan. And so like at the very end, they all like get together and to take the picture instead of saying cheese, they say Si Se Puede. Mm-hmm. And the teacher's there saying it and she is cheesing it and she looks just like that meme where it's like 45-year-old white woman saying gracias to the waiter at the Mexican restaurant.
Does look like it was post it.
So her. It was so her. We should do like I don't know if you can use screenshot on Disney Plus? Because you can't on Netflix.
I don't think you can. I'll try it. You can't on Hulu either.
I'll try it. We'll see. I need to get the Hulu login. I keep forgetting. Because I really want to watch that fucking show.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. For HBO. I got it.
Right. But that's everything we have to say about Gotta Kick It Out. Please watch it. It's on Disney Plus for who knows how long, forever, hopefully. And
we're coming right back with shit about Lizzo.
Woo!
Welcome back. We're having a whole Lizzo moment. Her name is Melissa Vivian Jefferson.
Oh, yeah. Well, before we go into that.
I'm going to call her Vivian. Vizzo.
I'm concerned. No. So before we start, we have a series that we've only done two entries in, but it's Women We Admire. She did Chelsea Handler. I did Robin. And today we're going to do Lizzo together through such big lesbians.
Right, because the intention was always for like me to talk about someone I admire, Mario to introduce each other, but Lizzo
Specifically women.
But Mario and I are like...
Both obsessed.
Yeah, we should go to the doctor and get our heads checked.
I just want to see her in concert so bad.
Yeah, we're going
to
go.
But if you wanted to lead this one, since I led the other one, by all means.
You want me to?
Yeah. I feel like you're on
but
it.
But then, like, when I read, I say so much. Okay, I'm not going to say Okay, so...
You did really good that one time.
I had to, like, constantly think about it. All right, I'm going to read... What just happened? I have so many notes. Okay, I'm going to start with Mario's nerds. Mario's nerds.
Mine aren't nearly as detailed as yours.
I'm so nervous. Mine aren't even mine.
Okay, we can go back together. It doesn't have to be just
okay. All right, so her name was... It was Melissa Vivian Jefferson.
Well, that's her legal name.
That's her legal name. She goes by Lizzo, which I did not know was a combination of, like, the end of Melissa and Hova. H to the Izzo... Like, that's how
like
she came up with Lizzo.
Is that the Jay-Z song?
Yeah.
Okay, yes. That's where I found that out. She was like, oh!
That's so cool. I just thought it was, like, a nickname.
I also love that, like, her biggest icon is also named Melissa. Missy Elliott.
Oh, my God. Yes, I didn't even think about it.
Yeah.
I'm so obsessed with this bitch. Okay.
Famous Melissas.
She was born in Detroit, Michigan. She began singing gospel music.
As a child.
She moved to Texas when she was a preteen. She loved NSYNC and Backstreet Boys. I hear you, girl, because I loved NSYNC, too. I was obsessed with Lance. That was my knee crack guidance, by the way. I'm so sorry.
I was obsessed with Justin. And, oh, my God, did you see that picture of Justin Timberlake's dick?
No.
It's, like, not actually his dick, but it's, like, the dick print in his pants. He's packing. Like, I was not expecting it.
He looks like a hawk to me, and I would never make love to
him. Also, he might be cheating on his wife.
Yeah, I saw that.
Did you see that? Oh my God.
Raise your hand, guys, if you're surprised, and then email me and let me know if you raise your hands. Are you serious?
He got cheated on by Britney, and it destroyed him.
He cheated on Britney, too. They were mutually cheating on each other.
Were they? Yes. I thought he cheated on her, and that's why he broke up with her.
He's a total fucking dog.
Is he?
Yes, he cheated on Cameron Diaz so many times.
Did he?
Yes.
Oh, my God. I need a lesson.
I think he's skeevy. I'm not a big Justin Timberlake fan.
So Lizzo's always loved Beyonce and Missy Elliott, and she began playing the flute in the sixth grade. Mm-hmm. She was also teased for being too white, and I feel like this is something that's very unfair to black kids that happens to them a lot.
I have something to say about that.
Oh, go ahead.
So being half white and half Hispanic, I'm never white enough to be with white people, and I'm never Hispanic enough to be with Hispanic people. Kim is probably my first full, like, Hispanic friend. A lot of my friends have always been mixed, and it is a thing. Like, it's weird to be a mixed kid. Like, no, it's strange.
Like, they discuss this in the Selena movie a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, being a Mexican-American.
Yeah.
You're never American enough to be considered an American, but you're never Mexican enough to be considered Mexican.
Yeah.
I totally get what you're saying.
It's a weird area to be in, and because of that, my friends are always, like, my high school boyfriend was German and Mexican.
Oh.
Like, it's this weird place you live in because you don't want to look for the validation, but, like, also validation's never going to be there.
Yeah. So,
it's weird. When I read that, I was like, oh, I totally understand, Missy. Because you're just, like, that weird white kid, but you're black, and that's all that people think about. Like, you don't act like a typical black person. They call you don't look white. Like, it's so...
I remember hearing people say, like, Oreo.
Oh, my God, that's so offensive.
It really is.
Oh, my God.
I got called...
I remember hearing that.
Yeah. Yeah. Was it a coconut? Did I get called a coconut?
I wasn't there. I don't know.
I think I was a coconut. It's like you don't act Mexican enough. You're brown on the outside, but white on the inside.
Yes.
A coconut.
Yeah, it makes sense. Jesus. And he's not brown. He's so pale.
I used to be very brown.
Oh.
I was
darker too.
When I went outside, I get dark.
Yeah.
Like, I get, like, very dark, especially my neck.
Yeah.
I know.
Such a racist thing. Okay, keep going. The first thing that popped into my head was racism. Because it's running rampant, guys.
It really is.
I'm being racist. Okay.
I mean, she... Never mind.
I did. We don't need to say it. I'm not going to say it.
I'm not saying it.
I made a racist comment earlier. Mario's going to cut it out. Because I didn't realize how racist it was. Because all my Hispanic family says it.
Yeah.
I learned a lesson and I will not be repeating it. Including on this podcast.
Good job.
Thank you.
But she dropped... Going on, she... graduated high school, went to college, and dropped out to pursue entertainment. And she had no backup plans. That's all she was aiming for. She was homeless, living in her car, and then her dad died.
This broke my heart.
Yes. And with that, she ended up moving to Denver, or from Denver to Denver.
And then to Minneapolis.
And then Minneapolis. Mm-hmm. And in Minneapolis was where she started, like, being in girl groups.
Yeah.
Because... I read somewhere it was something in regards to her not feeling confident enough in herself that she wanted to be a part of a group as opposed to solo at first.
I feel like I read that too.
And so she was originally in a group called Lizzo and the Larva Inc. And then
I love that name.
That's a great name. And then she ended up moving on to joining a group called Chalice.
Which I think is very... What's the word that you taught me?
I don't know.
The front of Kim Kardashian's Met Gala dress. You were like, it looks very, and it refers to like a vagina shape.
Oh, Yannick.
Yannick. So that's a very Yannick name.
Or the Yannick chalice?
Only for visual. Yeah,
the chalice. I totally can see that.
The chalice is like the womb. Like, that's the cup. That's the...
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I see it. I love it. I see it.
Okay. Sorry. I had to school Mario again on my vagina.
Bright pink cervix.
No. I love that story.
I love that story too.
It's my favorite story.
Oh my God. I was dying when I was editing it. Like, I was like, oh my God, I forgot about this.
It actually happened. My legs were up in the air in stirrups, and Daniel and the PA were looking at my cervix.
I'd be so embarrassed.
I was really pissed.
I would be too.
Get out of my vagina.
Literally. But this is when she actually got noticed by Prince, and they performed with Prince, and she was on one of his songs. Boy Trouble, but she's not credited as being on it. And I actually listened to it and I could not really make out her voice.
Yeah.
Did you listen to it too?
Mm-mm.
Oh.
I'm not surprised though.
I mean, she was doing background vocals, I guess.
Kesha was on a Flo Rida song she never got credit for. And yeah. You wouldn't really pay attention.
No, I knew it was her.
How?
Because it sounded like her.
Oh. I didn't know Kesha at the time I listened to that song, so.
Yeah, no, it sounds just like Kesha.
It does now.
This is her. This is her.
Yeah.
And then she came out with, like,
TikTok. But if she didn't tell me, then I wouldn't have known. Because I didn't know of Kesha at the time that song came out. So I didn't think about it.
Gotcha. You know, I didn't realize Flo Rida's name was Florida.
Oh, my God. The day I realized that, I hated him. I was like, I can no longer support this man. This is the worst pun I've ever heard in my
life.
Isn't
it?
So bad.
I was like, oh, he's
like, you know, because we ride in the flows. Shut the fuck up. Go home.
Well, that's something I thought.
Ride your flow
I didn't realize it was spelled Flo. I thought it was Flowrid.
That would have made more sense.
A or something. Yeah, I'm no, like, okay, no. He rides the flow, whatever.
He was and trying so hard to be cool. He sounded stupid.
And he's from Florida.
He came back to Lizzo.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. I'm with you. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. Fuck you, Flo Rida.
So anyway, but she released her first solo album in 2013 called Lizzo Bangers, and it was on the record label Totally Gross National Product, which I think is like...
I love her so much.
That wasn't hers. That was somebody else's.
No, but it's the fact that, like, she's like, yeah, you know that played a factor in her being like, yeah, I'm a fucking sign with this gross I'm national sure. product. Fuck totally. Yeah, I would support it.
But this album got her recognized by Virgin Records, which led to her getting an actual record label. They actually just, well, a deal. They don't know if, like, she just, they got dropped afterwards, but they redid this album with better sounds because it was a good album. And that's all she did with
Virgin. She must have gotten dropped. That's what makes the most sense.
But then in 2015, she released her own album called Big Girl, Small World on her own record label, just like Robin did. Like, she started her own label just so she could self-produce and do what she wants to do. And it was BGSW.
Amazing.
Big Girl, Small World record label. This got her a record label or deal with Atlantic Records, which is what caused her to become famous. So in 2016, she did the Coconut Oil EP. And that peaked at
number 44.
And Good as Hell was on this
album.
Yeah. And that kind of got her a lot of notice because it's a good ass song.
But still not enough.
Of course not. Of course not. But it helped her get exposure. She went on a tour in 2017 around the country to get more well known. And it helped some. And then Juice came out in 2019.
Michelle Obama.
What about her?
At the end of 2017, Michelle Obama and Barack Obama released a list of this music they'd been listening to, and Juice was on there.
That was this summer.
No.
Yes.
Was it this summer?
That was this summer.
Okay, never mind. I didn't think so. Like, the article I read.
Because Juice just came out in 2019.
My bad.
But anyway, she was also on RuPaul's
Drag Race. And Kimmy loves Juice. Kimmy loves Juice.
I love the music video for Juice.
I do too, but Kimmy likes, like, I love Juice. I'm like, okay, I guess I'll turn off tempo.
Oh, I just played the whole album.
We had a certain amount of time to get to the club.
Oh, okay. Okay. But Juice had just come out, and this was her first ever radio single that got, like, big play, which was amazing for her.
It's a really good song.
But then she was on RuPaul's Drag Race around this time as well. Like, it was around April or May. So, like, she was just coming up. Everybody's, like, paying attention to who she was. And then... She's
didn't
on Drag Race.
Didn't they do Juice?
They did Good as Hell.
Good as Hell, okay.
And it was an amazing lip sync.
Oh, I need to watch it. I've never seen it.
Everybody, I think this helped her garner a big gay following. This is when everybody's like, oh, we're paying attention. Like, at least in the gay community. Honestly, that is the way to get the gays. If you go on Drag Race, which is like the NFL of the gay community.
Sure.
You will get a fan or a following. So she has a very big gay following now because of that. And then, of course, her message and everything about her. But that was a lot of people's exposure to her initially. And then from there, she also released Because I Love You in April. And
I love that song.
I love the whole album.
No, but like
except for Jerome. I do not like Jerome.
I get it. But that song, man.
No, it's good.
That song. It hits different. I can't.
No, my favorite soulmate. I love Soulmate too,
but Cause I Love You is just like, I think what it is like I had heard all of her bops and then I heard Cause I Love You when I listened to the Tiny Desk concert.
Oh.
And then I was like, oh shit, like this woman has like fucking range. Depth.
Yeah.
Well, range obviously, but like also it's not just about bops and feeling good. Like there's other shit there too. And I think I have like this pull towards that song.
It's a great song.
It's a great,
there's a reason it's a titular song.
It's so good.
But also she, had a song used, well, Truth Hurts was used on a Netflix movie called Someone Great. I never seen it, never heard of it.
Me either.
But this is apparently what got everybody, like, listening to it, and it started to chart.
Makes sense, though.
And so, quickly, her record label was like, we're releasing a deluxe edition. The last, like, 5 singles you released, including Truth Hurts, are being added to 'Cause I Love You.
Okay.
So it can count towards record sales.
And I'm sure she was like, great, wonderful.
No, she was here for it. She loved Truth Hurts. And so, it happened. And now, like, her album, it was, like, charting forever. Truth Hurts was number one for like 6 weeks in a row. So it tied the Fancy's record.
Yep.
Unfortunately,
didn't beat it. We talked about that drama.
Yeah. But then she just recently collaborated with Ariana Grande on Good As Hell.
And remix. It's good. Their voices pair really well together.
I just expected more.
Yeah.
I wanted more.
I did too.
Because I feel like Ariana, like, this is a great song to go in.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're going to feature on this song, you should add something to it that Lizzo hasn't already added. And
yeah.
I feel like Ariana did. Her voice is beautiful.
But Lizzo also signed off on what was released.
Of course.
So.
But I mean, if Ariana fucking Grande said, I want to be on your song, that's what I'm putting on. I was like, okay, here you go.
Yeah.
Sign.
I'm here for it. Their voices. So for me, it's about the powerhouse. Like, those voices together sound so good. I wish there was more. I wish that Ariana had, like, her own verse.
Yes.
Instead of just, like, was the girl talking back.
Yeah.
But I also feel like I get why they did that. Because this song, like, and I have this in my notes about, because I wrote what I love about Lizzo, and that's what I'll get into next. But, like, this song I love so much because it's not just, like, Lizzo trying to build herself up. It's actually a narrative. Like, she's talking to a friend or a sister or whatever. And then Ariana kind of, like, fills in that voice. And I feel like...
It makes sense.
It makes sense to me. I wish there was more, though. But I always wish there was more Ariana Grande.
I don't. Did you hear about her concert recent?
No.
Tim, the guy, Luis's boyfriend.
What?
Went and saw Ariana Grande.
In Atlanta.
And Luis did too. But she brought the people from Victorious out on stage to perform with her.
Yeah. I saw that on Instagram. I didn't realize it was Atlanta. I thought it was Albany.
No, it was Atlanta.
Yeah.
I think it was Atlanta. Yeah, they went to
Atlanta.
I believe you. And he's like, it was really cool. And I was like, oh, that's great. Yeah.
If you watch that show, I didn't watch that show.
I don't either.
I should have, actually.
So I
will say that the day that... backing up to what Mario said about Truth Hurts, she has also said that she would have quit music. Like, the day that it made the chart, she was actually thinking about quitting music. Her manager, like, came and talked to her and was like, it's about, like, you and your music and not, like, what the world's perception of that is. Like, you always still have it. But she wasn't gaining any mainstream attention, and it was really getting down on her. And the reason, I feel like we should have said this, but the reason we're talking about Lizzo, for me, it's like the 8 nods that she got from Grammy. People are pissed about it, and it's like, go fucking suck a dick, because she has been around.
She's earned this shit.
For fucking ever. She lived in her car. You guys love that storyline when it was Katy Perry. Everybody ate that shit up.
No, Jewel too.
So now a black woman is doing it, and she's really fucking good. She's so good.
And she's co-signed by Prince.
How can you argue with Prince?
Exactly.
He's dead. Shut up. Sorry. So this is why we chose her this week. Stop. We're so proud of her Grammy nods. This is like a big moment for her. And we're hard store Lisbons.
Lisbons. Okay. We're hardcore Lisbons. You can't keep that in the
I feel
show.
Like I can't talk anymore. I'm done. Okay. So I have a whole bunch of notes about Lizzo, but Mario pretty much covered everything I said. Mine are just more detailed. I did want to add. She will be doing the final, the final episode this year of,
SNL?
Yes.
Is she really?
She is.
I don't even fucking watch SNL anymore.
Me either. But get this, it's also the final one from this decade too.
Oh my God.
So
that's
she's,
sick.
I can't wait to see her.
It's just
she's
like,
funny on Instagram. She's got to be hilarious. Scripted.
I hope so. She wants to be an actress too.
She has. Hello. She was in fucking Hustlers. Bitch, you're an actress.
I heard she was just like a cameo in Hustlers.
Yeah, no, it was. She said it. She was like, I wanted to be in it, but I couldn't because of touring. And then they added a date just for me to go in. She's like, I have a small role, but I'm in it. And that's all I care about.
Aww.
So it doesn't matter. So she's going to be in SNL and I'm so jazzed.
I'm going to watch it.
Yeah. It's going to air on December 21st.
Is that...
And Eddie Murphy will be there.
Oh, as the musical guest?
Yeah.
He's the musical guest?
No,
she's
the musical guest.
But is she going to be in the skits?
She's going to be in some of the skits.
Okay,
not
she
all
better
of them.
Be.
Yeah.
She better
I
be.
I hear you. I hear you, queen. All right, so here's my favorite Lizzo moments, right? I read this.
Great one.
First of all, if you haven't followed her on Instagram, you should.
Her Instagram's everything.
Her, it's so good. It's uplifting. It's fun. There's twerking. I'm obsessed with twerking. I love butt cheeks. Like,
she's the flautist.
Oh my God. She's amazing. So she said that I learned in the last 24 hours that being emotionally honest can save your life. Reaching out may be hard, but as soon as I did it, I was immediately covered in love. I struggle with being emotionally honest, having emotions on a daily basis. So it's so reaffirming to read things like that.
Absolutely. You're not alone.
Yeah. That's good. I love the video compilation of her saying bye, bitch.
Have you seen it? No.
It's so good. There's like little like 20-second clips of her being like, bye, bitch, bye, bitch. But it's like in concert venues and in restaurants. And then the final one is like, hi, bitch. And she's coming down an escalator. Shit is everything. It's so good. Her live performance of Truth Hurts.
From where?
In the BET.
Awards?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh my God. That was everything. She busted out that flute, started twerking.
Rihanna was living.
And she was on set on a fucking cake. Everyone is dressed. They look like a cake. They look like a moving cake. It's just, it's everything.
I loved her VMA performance with the giant ass.
Yes. Oh, that's good too, but it's not better than the cake.
Well, I just love afterwards, she, with the tweet about her trying to shove it in the overhead compartment.
Yes.
And she shared that shit. I loved it.
I think it's Marie Claire that does song association videos where they give you like a word.
Oh, I didn't watch it.
Yes, she has one. She's the only person in the history of it to ever get all 15.
What?
Yeah. No one. I think the only other person was Camila Cabello.
Ew.
She got 14 out of 15, but Lizzo got 15 out of 15. She's like, that's right, bitch. And they had to bleep her out so much. It was hysterical. She's like, that's right, bitch. I'm going to keep coming, bitch. And I was like, oh my God.
She was on the cover of Vogue.
She was on the cover of Vogue.
Which is fucking huge.
Okay.
Because Vogue is notoriously white.
It is. And even Kanye was on the cover of French Vogue. Like, it wasn't even the American Vogue.
But I will say that Anna Wintour has been trying to reach out.
I think Anna Wintour is on the train. I think she's getting it. I think she's moving over into all women, not just one set.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
I think she's getting there.
I was like, the Trump train? What?
No, not that train. No one gives a fuck about that train. It's invisible. My other lighthearted Lizzo thing is the Ursula performance on her Instagram.
Yes.
She still should have been cast.
They still haven't cast Ursula.
Oh, maybe she will. I don't know. My last and final favorite Lizzo moment is the Tiny Desk concert.
It was so good.
Mario told me for weeks, Jessica, you have to watch this. Jessica, you need to watch this. And I finally sat down and watched it. And I went from happiness to sadness to... just, it was a very emotional thing to watch. Mm-hmm. And then again, I've said this before, but the crowd was so diverse. It was absolutely fucking incredible.
She speaks to everybody.
Everybody loves Lizzo. And so my favorite songs is what I have next.
Okay.
Tiny Desk is also where she said, if you can love me, my big black ass, and this tiny, tiny little desk, you can love yourself every single day. That is some deep shit. You have to think about it. Like, if you can love me, you can love yourself. That's hard, right? Yeah. Like, that's a tough thing to grasp.
Absolutely.
So, my favorite songs. You ready?
Yep.
Truth Hurts. And I have a whole little spiel about Truth Hurts.
Go.
So, my daughter stopped listening to Side to Side, which is basically about fucking so much your legs hurt. And respect it. Like, sex is fun. You should... that should be the... have a sex injury. But, as an adult, my daughter is six. She has no idea what she's singing. Side to Side, she doesn't know.
She's been there all night. She's been there all day. It's been a really long, long one.
She thinks it's like riding a horse. I don't know.
Bike. No, the video's a bike. She's riding a bike.
And again, I don't shy away from these conversations, but my daughter has not asked me what it's about, which means that she's not ready to hear the answer. In my opinion, that's how I parent. You don't like it? Fuck off. Raise your own child.
Oh.
I'm just saying, like, I hate when people try to give me parenting advice. We're doing just fine. We're doing amazing. Okay? My children are very well done. A lot of people don't like it. I prefer
medium rare. I'm joking.
People don't like that I raise my children without religion. People don't like that I answer my children's questions honestly. People don't like that I tell Danny he has autism. Like, I've gotten shit.
We're in
for
the
that.
South, girl.
Yeah, we're in the. So, like, fuck off. Like, I don't care. I'm doing what I want to do. But Madeline finally stopped singing about having sex all night to, like, not being someone's side chick.
Uh huh.
And I felt like I was winning as a parent. Thank you, Lizzo. Thank you. Because it's one thing to be like, shh, don't sing that around daddy. To like, never, ever, ever, ever be a side chick. And then they high five. Like, it's a beautiful moment in my life. My other one is Tempo.
Oh,
Missy Elliott. I mean, I can't.
I love tempo.
But I also have so many issues about my body after having kids.
Same.
And that in the video is so awesome because they have all the skinny bitches like bouncing off the cars. Yes. Because the beat is so strong that only the heavy women can be on the ground.
Uh-huh.
I fucking love that shit. And also it's my son's favorite Lizzo song.
Oh, really?
He has a playlist on my MP3 player and he was like, you have to add Lizzo. Like that was the first song he wanted and he wanted tempo.
Aww.
He loves tempo. And because I love you. It's just raw and it's real. It's amazing. It shows her vocal talents. Mm-hmm. If you had any questions, watch this. And then also Good as Hell. And it's because of the narrative.
Yeah.
I'm not telling myself. I'm not singing about myself. Like I'm talking to a friend, a homie, someone that needs to be uplifted.
Yeah.
And I love that that perspective is taken. You don't see that often.
Absolutely.
That's my Lizzo.
What?
Cha. And basically, she's been working for a fucking long time. Her music is groundbreaking. It's different. It's beautiful. It's uplifting. It's sad when necessary. Like, it's just...
She deserves all the praise and recognition she's getting now.
So get off her ass. Or go kiss her ass. Unless she wants you there. Yeah, if she wants you there, it's fine. But, like, back the fuck up.
You know one of my other favorite Lizzo moments?
What?
It's when Frankie Muniz offered to be her purse.
I did not know this existed.
Girl, somebody drew fan art of him holding all her shit, following her around on a leash. It's his profile picture on Twitter.
That's amazing.
He's a Lizzo stan.
Yes. Oh my God, I'm so into it. Okay. You want to do ray of lights?
Absolutely. Okay. So, do I have a ray of light for this week? I did. Did I? Don't I? Don't I?
Oh my God. My husband's truck finally died. It needed to die. This thing is probably like
20 years old.
15 to 20 years old. It's not turning on and I'm so grateful because it meant that I got a new car. And I took Mario for a ride in it before we started.
It's very nice. My knees were against the dashboard, but it was very nice.
Well, I told you to move the seat back.
I couldn't figure it out.
Why didn't you say anything?
Because you were talking.
Oh.
And I was like, this is important. It was a
big emotional moment.
I can't interrupt this. I'll suffer.
Oh,
and if we die, if we crash, I'll die.
Interrupt me. This is so
stupid. My knees will go up into my head. Okay. It'll be fine.
I can't even talk to you right now. Who are you? Who even are you? My other ray of light, which Mario does not think is a ray of light, is that I've mentioned before that we have like a fan at work and she's a genuine fan. She listens and she likes it and she talks to me about it. And it occurred to me that we all work in the same part of the building now. And one morning I was like, oh my God, she loves us. Like, let me call her over and introduce her to Mario. And I was like, hey, Elizabeth, this is Mario. She immediately slapped her hands over her mouth and she was like, oh my God, I'm obsessed. And it was this total fangirl moment for her. And Mario shut the fuck down.
I did not.
Was like, oh my God, thank you. And he turned pink and like he couldn't even talk to her.
I wasn't
and
ready. Was I'm so,
so
sorry.
Sweet. And it was so endearing because they both had this same reaction to each other. Mario was so grateful. She was so grateful. And then I go back to my desk and Mario's like, I'm immediately thinking about ways to apologize to her. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about?
I was so awkward.
No, my God.
He
was so humbled and he was so nice and he was so just even endearing is what you were. And I hate that you, and I told him this already, I want to say it again. I hate that you got in your own head about it because I thought you gave the loveliest first impression. Well, and she clearly was like, oh my God, he was so nice.
Was she?
Yes.
I don't know.
Yes. She is so sweet and down to earth. Mario is blushing now, guys. Mario got in his own head, basically, and it was really, really sad because he should have enjoyed it a little bit
more. I just wasn't ready for it. I have
ready
to emotionally...
for what? For
I
someone to, like, gush over you?
Yes. For anything. Because I, as an empath, I can't just get bombarded with feelings like that. I don't know how to react. It freaks me out.
I'm the one with emotional issues.
Well, no, I'm fully able to acknowledge my issues, express my emotions. What my thing is I just have to prepare myself for it. If I can prepare myself for it, I can handle it just fine.
I just thought it was sad things. Like, it ruined Mario's home morning. I felt really, really bad.
Well, it wasn't ruined.
It wasn't ruined. I couldn't focus.
Because I was like, oh my God. Oh my God. I was so awkward.
You were not. I swear you weren't. You were exactly
like,
the way
I you said, okay, we're going to meet her today. Be ready. I had been emotionally ready. I'm like, it's so great to meet you.
I'm impulsive.
I'm not.
I'm so impulsive.
I have to think about it 9 times before I do it.
I'm like the one that's like, oh yeah, you want an ass tattoo? Let's go tonight. Oh, this one looks great. Even though the sign on the door says possible hep C infection. Let's go here. Like, I'm that friend.
No, I'm that one who's like, for example, there's a guy on my team who watches RuPaul's Drag Race. And so I was like, okay, I want to talk to him about RuPaul's Drag Race. So by the end of the day, I had to talk to him about RuPaul's Drag Race. And the whole day I had to psych myself up just to talk to him about RuPaul's Drag Race. And now he's cool.
Guys, I can't.
Like, I have to emotionally prepare.
Because I love Mario, but like, no.
And so I was just like, oh God, oh God. I was so awkward. I was so awkward. That's all
you were not,
on.
I swear. I would tell you. I'd be like, Mario, the fuck was wrong with you? Why didn't you say anything? Give her a hug, something. But like, you were just like, Mario. You were like, oh my God, thank you. Oh. It was so sweet. That was my ray of light. Although apparently it was like a dark of light for Mario.
No, I was just really...
A ray? A circle?
I was my own... My inner saboteur came out.
She thought you were lovely.
I hope so.
I was like, here's her name. Find her on Skype. Like,
I didn't know. I was like, I can't embarrass myself further.
I don't know what to say.
Elizabeth, it was so lovely meeting you. Thank you so much for being so enthusiastic. And I'm so sorry for being so awkward.
She was legit like, oh my God, I'm so upset. Like, it was a real moment for her. And Mario was like, dang.
Well, and I knew I felt it. Like, yeah. I felt it. And I was like, she legit likes it.
Yeah.
Like, that was really humbling. And like, I was so happy to know that.
You came off so lovely, I swear.
I hope so.
I would tell you if you were an asshole.
I hope so. Oh my gosh.
Mario's like, thanks. Bitch, my ray of light. Work. I'd be like, asshole, she's our one fan.
That's true.
Like, just shut up.
Oh my gosh. So my ray of light is I was able to successfully open and not damage my iPod and replace its battery, and now it's working perfectly, and it's like a brand new iPod, and I'm
so
proud.
It looks beautiful.
And then I got an iPod dock to put it on my desk, so it looks like I have a like it looks
fancy.
He's
so proud he came over to my desk and showed me.
I did, because it looked really good. It looked really good. But we really have to go, actually, because somebody has to go out to dinner with her family at 3:30 in the fucking afternoon for dinner.
You're all, like, older than 60, guys.
Girl,
well, except for...
I know, my family doesn't eat before 7. If it's before 7, you're not allowed to eat. Like,
oh, no, we
unless
eat
it's
when
Thanksgiving.
We want.
Unless it's Thanksgiving.
No, we eat when we want in this fucking house. You're oppressive Mexican.
I don't know if it's
bullshit.
like the Spaniard influence, because Spaniards eat late. Like 9:30, 10 o'clock at night for dinner.
No. I'll tell you what happened is my father-in-law got done with church and he's like, I'm ready to eat now.
Oh, okay.
And so we're like, okay, I guess we're going 30 minutes early.
Shit.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys so much for listening. Like, great, review us on iTunes, Stitcher, Spotify, whatever the fuck else we're on that you listen to us through. Email us if you have anything. Jasmine, we're still waiting on your email, and I'm going to keep bringing this up until you
No, he's not. I'm going to make it stop. You email
she
us
actually,
when you fucking feel
she
like
She actually
it.
Has it saved in her draft. She says it's not ready. I'm like, oh, hey, girl.
What a sweetheart, Jasmine. Take your time. Don't let him bully you into this. This is not a Scooter Braun situation. We have fan interaction. You fucked it up.
I didn't mean to. Oh my God.
He didn't fuck it up. I'm just kidding.
I'm so sorry.
You
I'm so sorry.
Apologizing. I'm so mad at you right now. But if you guys want us to review Paris Hilton's sex tape, let us know, since I thought that's what we were doing today anyway.
I don't know if I'm down.
It's Paris Hilton. You've already seen it.
Have I?
Yeah. There's cookie pictures posted of her all over the internet.
Well, I think I've seen, like, a screenshot of her, like, in, like, the green thing. Like, the green...
I'm into it. We can watch it. Thanks, guys, for listening. I'm going to go put on jeans now.
All right. Talk to you later. Bye.